while. So here. What's up, guys? How's it going out there in our tapes network? We're back. Look, I got some iodized fucking salt crystal bullshit. Got some extra virgin olive oil. Actually, don't want that spill anywhere. I got some Lysol all-purpose cleaner because I had to clean somebody's mouth out with soap. Because people were saying cuss words on here all day. I don't have time for cuss words. Fucking... yeah, so we're here on the Artips Network, guys. It's got, we're a little late, sorry about that. It's just me and Isaac on here right now, cause Funkle is somewhere else, and, we're gonna have to unlock him, so, he's not here. Even if we unlocked him, I don't even know how he would show up yet, so he's eventually gonna be unlocked, cause he'll eventually show up here, but as for now, it's us, buddy, it's us! We're the Artips Network, we're going to Deathstalk tomorrow. In the morning, we almost didn't even do this fucking show. So, make us proud, guys, and let's start getting some donations. I got my goddamn Mothman pins in, finally. They look amazing. I need one of those. I'll grab one here in a second once, I got the other one on camera. We got those, and we got we finally get the Memories Records on Saturday. And we only have a few, so order that shit now. Make sure you get yourself a copy because the color copies are already getting fucking snagged up. Beer Break says the muscle man tool. Well, those guys, it's humid ASF out here too. At least it looks nice. I told you I don't want any cussing on the program. Joking. I want all fucking cussing all damn day. Fucking Mothman Prophecies, the movie fucking blows ass. It is not humid here, but it was hot. And I'm having my first beer of the day. Here we go. So, where's my chats at? 8 watching. 4 likes. Fucking ridiculous. Who's watching out there? Let me see you in the chats. Got the new Mothman pins. The new Narstock pins are in San Francisco, but they have arrived in the U.S. They're here. And you can get them for me. Make sure you reserve them because I'm going to be giving them out at Deathstalk. So if you want one of those Narstock mushroom enamel pins, they're only 5 instead of 8 because I really want, you know, it's kind of like a promotional item for a certain thing. I kind of just want people to have them. So get one of those if you want one. Otherwise, I'm pretty much just giving them all away at Deathstalk. All right, 8 watching, 4 likes. I'm all by myself up here. Fungal is nowhere to be seen. Jimmy is on the premises, though. It doesn't look like he has any interest in being on this show right now. Just kidding. I know he does. We had a show in the shop today, and it's getting winding down right now. Bob Dylan's grandma says, I passed by Point Pleasant yesterday. Hell yeah, the Mothman. Point Pleasant, West Virginia. Yes. I'm also going to throw a pot of coffee on. I need a pep. I would love a Red Bull. A Rage Bull would be so sick. But I didn't think about that until it was too late. So yeah, alright guys. It's the Nartapes Night Live. Maybe season finale. We might do one next week, not sure. This might be the season finale of the Nartapes Night Live, so let's get this fucking show popping off, guys. I'm gonna take a shot for you. Free of charge. How about that? Bree says, when your chips are too loud and you can't hear the darn TV. Oh, yeah, I know that. Oh, those chips you sent, Bree? Oh. Also, I'm gonna make s'mores out of those crunchy bars. Isaac. I'm gonna get some graham crackers, some marshmallow. And then I'm not going to put any Hershey's in there. It's just going to be a crunchy bar. All the ketchup chips are gone. And there's only one bag of All Dressed left. They were good soldiers. Strong. Himalayan salt still going strong. And have not had a chance to use the Montreal steak spice yet. But we'll do it when we get back in Deathstalk. Hey, maybe we can do that, Isaac. Steak for getting fat. Steak and lobster. Oh yeah, you have to steak the oven steak. That's the right way. Cause you gotta keep all them juices. If you're on the grill, that steak is gonna lose a lot of juice. Oh, Bree says, I use it on my ground beef too, not just steak. Oh, you use it for burgers. One time Isaac made burgers on the Skinny Fat with Skinny Jesus program, and they were some of the best burgers I've ever had in my life. That was also the time that he made ice cream, and that was awesome. I love strawberry ice cream. We didn't make, I wish we would have made mint chocolate chip ice cream. That's my favorite one. What's your favorite ice cream? That's what we like to talk about on the Narcotics Network. We're a bunch of cool musician guys living in LA, doing drugs, and we just want to know what your favorite ice cream is. Cheers to your favorite ice cream. Isaac Cortez is here. He says, yo! What up, Isaac? You know, I'm exhausted. I was up till 5 in the morning this morning working on new White Fang stuff with Uncle Funkle. And we have a new White Fang tape coming out next week. Surprise! All new songs. All new songs you've never heard. I think it's like seven new songs. Seven. Isaac says, where's Isaac? Where's Funkle? Isaac is over here. Funkle is nowhere to be found. He's on his way here. Bob Dylan's grandma says, I chilled with a frog and listened to Royal United Song Service today. It was tight. Hell yeah. Bob Dylan's grandma says, Cherry Garcia or Strawberry? Hell yeah. Cherry Garcia, that's my favorite, like, Ben and Jerry's by far to me.
Yeah, that was good.
Cheers. Isaac, you want to do one with me, actually?
Sure.
All right.
Why the heck not?
I don't like to drink alone. Isaac, where's your cool shot glass?
I don't know.
Where's your shot glass, Isaac? Where's your glass? Where's your shot glass? Where's your shot?
Just put it in now.
Where's your shot glass?
Okay.
Where's that going? Shot glass?
Alright.
Alright. They say that what doesn't kill you makes you stronger, so pour some tequila.
Okay, I'm here. I made it. How about that? Woo!
Oh, yeah. Here we go.
Cheers.
Cheers, man.
Cheers to you guys on network. Now, can you scoot over? Mm-hmm. One sec.
Isaac's gonna go puke. Free Bake says cheesecake ice cream, pistachio ice cream, banana peanut butter ice cream, key lime ice cream.
Yeah, me too. Key lime pie. Favorite pie.
My favorite pie is pecan pie.
And
cheesecake. I love pecan pie.
I love pecan pie too. I think key lime pie is the best pie.
I don't like key lime pie.
You're whack, dog. Because that shit's bomb.
I never had it.
There you go. Then you can't say you don't like it.
I don't like the yogurt.
It's not yogurt.
I know. That's what I'm saying.
What are you talking about?
Listen to me now. Listen to me now. Okay? It's my turn.
It's always your turn. I'm listening.
My turn right now.
I'm listening to you.
What was I talking about?
You're just saying you don't like key lime pie, but you've never had it. And then you said you don't like yogurt, but there's no yogurt in it.
I'm talking right now. Just kidding.
There's no yogurt in it.
So I know.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm talking about how as a kid, the Tillamook key lime pie flavored yogurt was whack.
That sounds disgusting.
It sucked.
That sounds whack.
Lime yogurt is not tight. It's like the sour of lime, but then the sour of yogurt do not go well together. Nice, what was it? Oh, it was from a certain Owl Lone.
Is that you?
Yeah.
Is this you?
Yeah.
You bought an LP?
She got the goddamn LP!
Alright.
Oh, Brie Bake says, what about banana cream pie? That is my, I make a really amazing banana cream pie, by the way. Okay, I'm going to tell you about this, Avalon. You want to hear about my banana cream pie?
See,
okay, well, then I won't tell Avalon.
Cause she,
you can tell me. Alright, I'm going to tell Avalon, but I'm just going to know the whole time that she's not going to... she'll appreciate everything else. There's a lot to appreciate.
It's like, how do you, for the
completely clean.
You have to rub it. Grab some paper towels or a sponge or something.
Yeah, you gotta rub it.
You have to scrub it.
You
gotta put that elbow grease in, bro. Life ain't easy, and neither is cleaning screens, my dog.
Banana cream pie. I get the...
It's annoying.
I get the Keebler the graham cracker crust. Then you line that motherfucking whole bottom of that crust with vanilla wafers.
That's right.
All the whole bottom and the side.
That's right.
And then you put your goddamn banana pudding all up in that shit. And then when you get that on top of the banana, you do another whole layer of vanilla wafers. And then banana circle, sliced fresh bananas. And then you put whipped cream on the top of that bitch. And then you sprinkle shaved almonds all over the top of that.
Delish.
It's mostly about the vanilla wafers and the fresh banana and the almonds and the whipped cream.
Yeah.
Also, you can do the exact same thing. And
you can make that shit without fake banana.
Yeah, you can make it with real banana. You can also make it with, a caramel cream pie. You can do a chocolate cream pie.
I imagine you would just have to make a meringue and then mix it with some blended bananas, and that would work.
Meringue-a-tang.
Meringue's easy. That's just egg whites.
What about a good old-fashioned cream pie? Like cream pie?
Oh, have you ever had bean pie?
No.
That's some fucking soul food shit, bro.
Bean pie? Tastes like sweet potatoes?
No, it tastes like
sweet potatoes.
No,
I like sweet potatoes are whack.
It's sweet. I don't know. It tastes like bean, but it's sweet. It's nice.
Like taro?
Taro's not bean. It tastes like bean.
What is taro, a root?
Taro's a root vegetable. Taro is another form of sweet potato, so...
Yeah, but I like taro. And ube.
It's different. It's different than the American sweet potato, that's for sure. But it comes from the same family. It's a root vegetable.
All right.
Taro's nice, though. And it's purple. Purple's a good color.
Purple is really cool. I really
like purple food. That's like, you know what I mean? You don't see purple food. I mean, you see grapes, cabbage.
Well, purple food's like supposed to be good for you.
Yeah.
Like cabbage, wine.
Wine is purple. Wine is definitely purple.
Beet.
Beet is like a dark red, purplish. Beets are supposed to be very, very good for you.
Yes. You know what else is good for me? It's goddamn sales.
That's right. We only have one sale right now. We're at $28.63. Thanks to a little someone. Brie Bake says, hi, Avalon.
Hello.
She said hello.
We really only have 8 watching right now?
There are only 8 people watching. Share that link, guys. What's up? Get your friends in
Smash
here.
Smash that goddamn link button.
Smash the link.
Here, I'm going to see if I can get
share the like.
It's pretty funny. Tyler, the creator,
Bob Dylan's grandma said eggplants are purple.
Posted a picture of some, like, a little kid or whatever, like, some teenager, and, like, now, I think he's dumb. He's, like, one of his pictures, like, I'm white, so what, or whatever, but, like, all these people are, like, bombing his Instagram now, and, like, just, like, there's, like, thousands of comments on all his pictures. He's, like, deleting all his pictures and, like, responding to all of them, like, getting all
Wait, so he posted a picture of, like, a kid?
Yeah.
With a baby?
With a kid. No, not the kid. Like a teenager.
You seen that one?
No.
The one where he's holding... I thought it was the one where he's holding up the baby.
No, he posted a picture of some dude so everybody would, like, make fun of him.
Ah.
Yeah. And they go to his account and then they're like, follow this guy. But it was meant to, like, bum rush his account and, like spam his account.
I see.
Yeah.
Well, they sorted that out, didn't they? Well, you know, the thing about Tyler, man, it's like, why are you going to get mad at anything that fool fucking says? Don't you know what he raps about?
Yeah.
Like, what are you talking about?
Eggplant, there you go.
Crazy.
Eggplant is real good. Kimchi is made from cabbage, which is,
not purple, but delicious and good for you. Anything, you know, usually anything pickled, definitely has some good properties for you if you're trying to eat good. Or eat well, as a proper English major would say. There's just something about the brine that just gives you all the shit that you need, you know? Isaac says, nasty bro, or wait, gnarly bro. All right. Hell yeah, what's up, y'all? Where we at? It's Gnar Tapes Night Live. It's Wednesday night. This is what we do on Wednesday nights. We do the damn thing up here in Studio G. If you haven't hit the like button yet, please hit that like button. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. And go on over to gnartapes.com/GTG and consider making a donation. Consider making a sale. We got the new Memories Royal United Song Service record in the shop. You can buy one of those. We We got the new Mothman pins up in the shop. You can buy one of those. We got all sorts of cool shit. We got the new tote bags in the shop. We got the legalized this shirt. We got Nartapes Network shirts. We got Nartapes Network pins. We got the Skinny Jesus Isaac Arita chibi pin. And there's lots of fun merch that you can go get out there on nartapes.com/GTG. Now, aside from all the physical merch you can buy, you can also donate for us to get fucked up or whatever, you know? For $5, you can make one of us take a shot. For 420, we'll take a dab. For 420, we'll roll a joint. For 420, we'll smoke some weed. For $1, we'll do a kissy time or a spanky time. There's lots of fun stuff we can do for you if you donate right now at nartapes.com/GTG. It's easy. Just go to the site, hit the like, and let's get some sales in there. How about that? Sound good, right? Is that good, right? Well, there you go. We'll get you some.
Alright, guys. It's the Nartapes Night Live program, and, we really appreciate, guys, what we do this for is because we're a band in Los Angeles, and when we're not on tour playing sold-out shows around the world for adoring fans making millions of dollars, when we're not doing that, we're here in L.A. at a recording studio online, begging for change.
Panhandling, if you will.
Yes.
Not busking. We're not busking.
Panhandling,
yes, we're doing that. We are begging. I used to call this show a very evolved form of bumming cigarettes. You know, like when you when you're at the party and you want to bum a cigarette off someone if you don't have any. This show is kind of like that, except it's very evolved, where the whole presentation of how we want to ask you for a cigarette. It's a little bit more ball. So yeah, come on guys, we can only do this show and all of our shows. you can bun cigarettes for the rest of your life, man. My paper.
Yeah, it's Q12. All right, guys, we got 12 watching and only 7 likes. Isaac says, so what did you guys eat? What, today?
We had Cypress Burger earlier.
I had a breakfast burrito, chorizo, and bacon. I meant to get sausage and bacon, but I got chorizo and bacon. And it was really good. It was intense.
Chorizo is intense as fuck.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know how people eat
Kimmy!
Chorizo. How do you eat chorizo, to be honest? Because, like, I feel like if I have one bite of chorizo, it feels like I ate a whole cow. In one sitting.
I guess it's just, I think the reason that it's crazy. It's just salty.
It's super salty, and then they mix it with the eggs usually, and it's like, it's just so much.
Man,
I'm so stoked
on these fucking Mothman pins.
Like, I honestly like soy rizo a little bit more than chorizo, just because it's not so, doesn't fuck you up.
You want to look at the camera?
Yeah, of course.
Give one of those to Avalon. Mothman?
Check this out, people.
What did you order? The Memories LP, right? Okay, good. But you can have one of these because you were the first order of the day.
Oh, thank you.
It's kind of hard to see just like the real Mothman.
All right, guys.
But it's in there. Check that out.
The next 4 sales over $20 get a free Mothman pin or any enamel pin of their choice.
How about that? Oh, Pooh Butt's here. Hell yeah. What's up, Pooh
Butt?
Pooh Butt! Show without Pooh Butt.
Smash that like button, guys. We're just getting started. We're just getting cooking here.
What's up, Kimmy? What's up?
So cool looking.
It's a great looking pin, man. It's good. It's low key, just like the real Mothman.
No, the real Mothman was not low key. A bunch of people saw that fool.
Everyone saw him then, huh?
Everybody in Point Pleasant. Yeah, we have 14 watching. 8 likes. Smash that like button. Zach Schraff's here.
What's up, Zach Schraff?
What?
Hey, Zach, I haven't shotgunned a beer in a while.
Yeah, I mean, doing strikeouts now, too. I was going to strike out.
Zach says, I was in Riverside today. For what?
What?
To commit suicide?
You didn't come and see us?
Actually, it's so funny. Back in the day, there used to be this sick shirt floating around Riverside. It said, it was like, homicide, suicide, Riverside. And then it had the bell. And wow. I was like, oh my God. And I've been like, I even hit up the Summer Twins girls because they like run that store. And I was like, do you remember this shirt? Because I really want one of those shirts. But they haven't.
Do they remember it?
Yeah, they were like, oh my God, I remember. Because it was like a bro shirt, you know, like the dudes with lifted trucks and dickies and the up bills on the hat. Like those fools would wear the homicide, suicide, genocide, Riverside shirt. Kimmy says, Riverside's whack. You live in Reno Valley. You can't say anything about that.
Zach Trump says it looks nice.
Yeah. Riverside's actually cool. What does a chief handkerchief say?
You guys ever rip slappies?
What are slappies?
What is a slappy?
What is a slappy?
Ricky, you should get a mullet. I've had many mullets. I kind of have one right now. All those girls, I don't think living without internet would be that bad, but it fucking sucks. Zach says, moving to Dina tomorrow.
Dina? Altadena? Pasadena?
Yeah, with Dina. Altadena or Pasadena?
Which Dina?
Probably the Pasadena, I'm imagining. But dude, what? Are we going to kick it? Dude.
Come through, Zach.
We got 16 watching, 8 likes, guys. Smash that fucking like button for me, please.
Let's shotgun some beers, Zach.
Yeah, let's do some shots.
Throw it down. Throw it down, Zach. Let's get it. Spencer's here. Dudes, I'll be in town the 10th through the 14th. Gotta make some time. Well, that's right before
Perfect.
We go to Europe. Same thing with Zach. Yeah, I'll roll through before you guys go to Europe. Yes.
Yeah.
Perfect. That's tight.
What Bob Dylan's grandma say?
He says, hey, Riverside is where I live, bro. Where in Riverside did you go? Did you go to downtown? Did you hit up the Mission Tobacco Lounge? Did you go to Back to the Grind? Did you have pasta at Mario's? Did you get a facial at the Mission Inn? Where'd you go? Did you go to Tio's Tacos and sit in the beautiful garden area they have there? Let me know. What's up? Kimmy says, same, BDG. Yup.
We got some coffee real quick. I'm in a sale! That's not the right song.
Very good!
All right, nice. What is that?
We're gonna find out though.
Oh boy. Oh, Kimmy says Montreal is cool, to be honest.
Mission Tobacco Lounge.
Okay. Oh, those guys are staying in rural Ohio makes me appreciate Riverside at least. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Appreciate
Riverside
it.
Is a much better place than anywhere in Ohio.
Sorry. If you live anywhere in Southern California, you're a better place than probably anybody else. Zach Trapp says hit the Mission Inn.
There you go. Mission Inn is beautiful.
Chief says, haha, my friend told me of it. He used to do it, but just fucking bong hit of cig tobacco. That broke morning remedy.
That's gross.
That is gnarly.
I smoke cigarettes, and I would never do that, because that's fucking nasty. You're gross. Kimmy says, I'm just kidding. Kimmy says, Taco Station is fire. I don't know if I've ever been there. Where is that? Puba says, how was your 4th? We worked all day yesterday.
I worked till 5 in the morning.
So, yeah, there you go. We didn't do shit other than work. Spencer says, just had $20. Hook me up with a tape when I see
it. Hell yeah!
Could we take some shots to that too, maybe?
Yeah,
take a shot each, and then when you come here, Spence, we'll sort you out, baby.
Your Coca-Cola shot glass is on my desk right here in the middle of the room.
Okay.
We bring also the coffee over here, guys. Say what? Oh, that's sale! Oh yeah, guys. Oh yeah. Buzzle's grandma says, ew, a bong hit of tobacco? Yeah, but in Australia, they do that kind of thing. It's called a cone. And they mix it half and half, half and half, tobacco and, half, marijuana. Alright, let's see what we got here. Oh, a nice little coffee from me. A strikeout and a shotgun for Isaac.
There you go. Who did that? Who did that?
Oh, God. I had to poop.
Who did that? Hell yeah. Hell yeah, Funkle.
I know. I was like, when he said he's only done it twice in the show, I was like, you did it more than twice.
I wanted to say something, too, but I was like, I don't want to.
You can't argue with him on that show.
Or just in general.
Yeah, in general.
I'm not trying to do that.
Oh, this little tiny baby bug. You're going to get fucked up if you're here. Oh,
that's the thing. Like, the cockroaches, whatever. The mice, okay. I hate mice. But the thing that, like, really fucks me up is the tiny little bugs that I've never seen before in my entire life. I'm like, what the fuck is that?
I think the Mothman's my favorite one.
What is that? I hate it.
I think the Mothman's my favorite pin, guys.
I fucking hate it.
You got another beer out of the case there, Isaac? I got a shotgun and do a shot. And... Hell yeah, Zach Stroud, that's my boy. You're my boy, dog. Yeah, guys, so these Mothman pins came out today, and these are my favorite ones I've done so far. I really, really like them a lot, and I think that they're like a really cool shape. They look really cool, and like, they're like a crossover where it's like it's not music or my artwork. It's like an actual like thing. This pin is based off the original eyewitness sketch from 1966, Point Pleasant, West Virginia. Pooba says, I'm bummed out. Why, Pooba? Chief says, haha, we do the half and half rip it. It is called a mole rip. From the mole pole, aka bong in the comfort of your mole hole. Bob Dylan's grandma says, tobacco is wacko. JK, LOL. No, yeah, a little tobacco never hurt anybody. Just killed him.
Some fools live their whole lives smoking, and they live.
It's like 100.
It's weird. It's fucking weird, man. You know? I mean, my grandpa died pretty early.
Oh, you?
Of it.
You have a shotgun.
Yeah, you too.
Oh, I need a dab too, huh?
Yeah, go get your shit. All right, thank you guys. Thank you, Spencer, for that donation. When you come into town, we'll sort you out. Thank you, Zach. For the shotgun and the strikeout. When you come to LA, to the spot, we'll sort you out as well. And there you go. Kimmy says, some tobacco tastes good. Very hard to find though. Yeah, it depends. If you go to Europe, they have bomb-ass tobacco in Europe. They got the bomb shit over there. It's pretty much, I have like this weird thing, this conspiracy thing in my mind where all the good tobacco that grows in America gets sent to Europe first, and then America gets like whatever tobacco is left, because I feel like there's some age-old pact between like the colonies and the rest of Europe and stuff, and we got our freedom, our independence. But, you know, that to me, that comes at a certain cost. So I feel like you can find the nice tobacco in Europe. I'm sure you can find the nice tobacco in the Middle East. And go to Virginia. They got nice tobacco in Virginia as well. If you're into, like, rolling tobacco and shit, Kimmy, you can go get some of the Stokabee. They have lots of different flavors. And it's nice tobacco. Pooba says, I messed it up and deleted my Spotify account, and Spotify took off your album, Pure Evil. Damn. Fuck them, dude. Why would they do that? Why the fuck would they do that?
Yeah, why would they take it off?
I don't know. Bullshit. That's bullshit, bro. I'm gonna kick their ass when I see Spotify next.
I don't give a fuck.
Kimmy says, sounds tasty. What's it called again? The brand is called Stokabee. Peter Stokabee. They come in brown pouches. All right. And they have different flavors.
Got my shot together.
They have different flavors, such as the Amsterdam Shag, the Danish Shag, the London Export, the Turkish Blend. It's just like,
it's a brown pack. Those are the best for sure.
It's the best shit you can get in America.
I like Amsterdam Shag.
I do too.
And the Norwegian.
That's the dark one. And then the Norwegian, it's like the next, not as dark. But yeah, that's some good, nice tobacco.
Careful. I'm about to do a strikeout, guys. If you don't know what a strikeout is, you're about to see it. I'm about to take a dab of THC concentrate. I'm gonna hold the dab smoke in while whilst I take a shot.
Poulet says, that's my favorite album by you guys. That's funny. Rocky says, I think all marriage record stuff is gone. Okay, we'll have to sort that shit out. Baldwin's grandma says, my connection is really fucked and it's getting cold out here. Bye, guys. Say hi to Fungal for me. I'm gonna buy your shirt either Thursday or Friday, Ricky. Bye, everyone. Hell yeah, BDG. We're not having shows this weekend because we'll be in Deathstalk, but we'll see you. Just buy it anyways. You can buy it off the site anytime you want. Kimmy says, okay, found it. Thanks, Isaac. Hell yeah, Kimmy. And she says, bye, BDG. Take care. BDG says, bye, everyone. And then Brie Bakes says, bye, BDG.
All right, here we go.
All right, Strike. Batter up. Here we go. Here we go. So first step is a dab. That's we call that the Strike One. If I was a baseball umpire. And then there you go. There's another shot. Strike Two. All right, pitcher is winding up. All right, coming in, crazy curveball. The pitcher's doing good. Strike three. You're out of there. You're fucking out of there. You're out of there. That's how, darling, you do a strikeout. It's incredible. Zach says, later, BDG. That sucks.
I guess marriage records problem.
No. Well, how about this, Poublet?
I mean, we run marriage records, so.
How about this, dog? How about if you put in an order today for a donation or anything? Well, do we have any of those CDs left? What is that? Oh, her thing. There you go. That's nice. That sounds nice. We can sort you out, Poublet, if you throw in a sale. We can sort you out with some MP3s, maybe, at least. Zach says, later, BDG. Brie Bake says, I scraped my Buster today. Got one of those herb grinders that look like a coffee grinder. It was caked with pure THC, ripped the fatty off it, and oh my god, R.I.P. Brie.
Nice.
All right, Zach, here's a shotgun for you.
Ooh, a strikeout with something else. Keep those strikeouts coming.
And here we go.
Woo. Yeah, I imagine that the marriage record stuff is off of Spotify because marriage is probably out of, like, whatever digital distribution deal that they had. Because we run marriage and we don't know any of that stuff. Because we barely run marriage. We kind of just steward it, to be honest.
All right, Poublet, you're broke till next week. Well, throw in that sale and then we'll sort you out. We'll sort you out with
give me another strikeout, guys, while I'm taking a poop.
We'll sort you out with some MP3s next time, Poublet. How about that? You like that? How about that? Alright. Well, so just to let you guys know what's going on, this may or may not be the season finale of Nartapes Night Live. And tomorrow we are leaving for Guerneville, California, which is north of San Francisco, to be at Deathstalk 3. I'm wearing a Deathstalk 1 shirt right now. Check that out. We miss it! Rock and back! And rock and back! We miss it! Is it 27? Yeah! I did it! Alright, that was for two strikeouts. Looks like someone's getting drunk tonight. Someone's getting drunk. I'm going to order him like three more. Yeah. Could you do me a favor? Hold on, let me add this up real quick. What are we at right now? 64. Is that what does it say?
It's
62.13. 62.13. Alright. I want you to do it on the computer. 62.13 plus 18 equals. Okay, so on the second window there at the bottom, there should not window, but like in that program, in this program, there should be a thing that says daily goal.
Oh yeah.
You see it?
Yeah.
Double click it, and then change it to 80-13.
80-13?
Yes. Okay, and then you're good. Thank you. Hell yeah, we got Avalon producing the show right now. That rips. Not only is she throwing in donations, she's working too. Like I was saying, this weekend we are going to Guerneville, California to be a part of Deathstalk 3, which is quite possibly the best music festival in existence. It's awesome. It's great. It's in Northern California, where the Redwoods live, and in Guerneville, California. It's going to be awesome. There's a ton of sick bands, and we have our own stage, the Narstock stage, where we have, awesome bands playing, such as Fields here from here in Los Angeles, Colleen Green, of course, The Memories, White Fang, Funkel, the whole Nartapes shit. So, if you live in California or in Northern California, I would suggest maybe checking it out. It's going to be a fun weekend. We're going to, probably do drugs and shit. We're going to be camping. It's a camping festival. That's another reason why it's so sick. Everyone camps for the most part, and it's just so much goddamn fun. I always have so much fun. By the end of Deathstalk, I'm just always like, man, I didn't know you can do that, like, have that much fun, and, like, feel that good, and it's just awesome. Fucking rips. Isaac says, legalize this! I will buy that shirt. You should! You should fucking buy it. I'll make it for you. I'll make it myself. And it'll be sick. Spencer says, back in the Olympia days, everything on Marriage was my shit. Hell yeah, what was your favorite Marriage release, Spencer? Are you an Adro guy, or are you a Rob Walmart guy? Or are you a yacht person maybe? I don't know. Let me know what your favorite Marriage shit is. Kimmy says, sounds tight, would love to go. It's this weekend, Kimmy. And it's really fun. There's a bunch of sick bands. We're actually selling tickets on our website. If you go to nartapes.com in the shop, you will be able to find passes to that. So, and the cool thing, the best thing about Deathstalk that's really, really awesome, for the most part, it's not just the festival goers who are camping. The bands also camp there too. So it's fucking sick, man. You'll have all these fools from bands playing at the festival that night, high on mushrooms and acid and ecstasy, and everyone's sitting around a campfire getting wasted, playing guitars and shit, and hanging out. It's fucking awesome. It's really, really, really cool. It's actually like one of my favorite things in the whole world ever.
I need to be there.
It's one of the
sometimes,
best.
Sometimes in like the middle of winter, or like, sometimes I'll even be in like the coolest place you ever imagined. Somewhere in the world, like Brazil or Australia, and I'll be like, I wish it was Deathstalk.
Deathstalk is sick.
All right, guys, so what? So I gotta do two strikeouts?
You gotta do two.
Kimmy says, sounds tight, would love to go. So I said, all the Adro.
All yeah. The Adro, hell yeah. All the Rob, hell yeah.
All the Adro, all the Rob.
Well, when you're here, Spencer, you can peruse what's left of the Marriage the Marriage fucking catalog. Dude, we have everything, not everything, but we have all the back stock here. So if you want to take a trip down memory lane, my dude, and you can come through. Zach says, say what's up to Wakefield and Danielle for me. Wish I could make it. I forgot that Nikki said he was going to play. But I also have a striking suspicion that
he's
not going to go there. I don't know if he's going to be there. TBH. I love that boy. But he's the type to forget about playing a big festival like that.
Or
but
not
I also,
forget. Just like not be able to figure it out.
Yeah.
And then not tell anybody he's going.
Yeah.
And then kind of like pretend like he forgot. To himself.
But I would also not be surprised if he was there, because he's supposed to.
Yeah.
So there you go. And he made it down to LA that a couple weeks ago, or like a month ago or whatever, and like that's tight, you know? So he's not so he can do it if he wants. Spence, who? He did. He lived with us, and then he moved back to Portland. Because he didn't want to come home with his tail between his legs. So he just went home.
Oh shit, we popped this on me and put me a shot?
Fuck. He went home.
Start
Just start it over.
I'm spacing out. I've already done
here,
one.
Let me, I'll heat this up.
Oh yeah, okay.
But yeah, I hope Nikki's there, dog. I really want to see. I hope he's there. I love that pool. That's my dog.
Yeah, it's for real. I really hope he's there.
That's my dog. I love that pool. You know, he could fuck up a million times, and you know, I'll still love him.
Yeah, me too. And I mean, I haven't been, you know, trying to think about it too much, but I hope he's gonna be at desktop. If he's not, then, you know.
Alright. This is good. I'll hold that. Alright. You're almost there.
Here we go, guys.
Strike out one.
This is my second.
Pack.
This is my second strikeout.
No, this is the first one for pack, though. Alright. There you go. Steve Reichman! Strike two! Right three, and you're out. Spencer says, wasn't there Lake or some shit used to chill with those dudes? Yeah, Lake is one of those bands, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Spencer says, for sure. And Isaac says, wear a green shirt right now on the show or at Deathstalk.
He wants to target easy targets when he assassinates us.
That's cool. I like you, Isaac. it's cool knowing.
What? Poobot just said something that blows my mind.
I just tried a root beer float for the first time right now. Did you like it? Are you into it? Pooh butt? Do you like that?
I've been
that?
Eating root beer floats since I was a little kid. A baby.
I didn't like root beer floats when I was a kid.
I was crazy for them.
Oh, not down.
Jimmy, what about you?
I honestly did not really like them either, but I did like the root beer.
I like them now.
I loved
See,
it
that was
immediately.
My thing too. That was my thing too when they were mixed. I was like, I don't know if I like this.
I loved it because it was like I don't know, because me and my cousins would do shit like that all the time. Like, me and my cousin Zach would go pick blackberries, because they're, you know,
yeah.
Oregon, they're everywhere.
Yeah.
And we go, like, grind them down in some milk and sugar and eat that shit.
That's pretty good.
Just with milk and sugar.
That's almost ice cream.
Yeah, but just like with berries and milk and sugar. We used to go pick berries ourselves. Also, we used to go pick these, like, certain flowers, and you can, like, pull them carefully off, and then you get a little nectar off the end of it. You know, those, like...
Oh, honeysuckles.
They're, like, purple, like, balls.
Yeah.
Yeah, honeysuckles.
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
We used to do that, too.
For the floats...
Those aren't floats. I like what you... I would eat that blueberry shit.
Coke floats. Yes. I used to do the 7-Up float all the time.
Oh, you know what I would... I mean, I like root beer floats now, but you know what I really would... What I would have liked as a kid, but never had? It's, like, orange soda one.
That one is amazing.
Yeah, like the orange cream. I never had that as a kid, but if I was a kid, that would be all about that, because I love Orange Julius.
So I guess...
And I love Juicy Whip.
When I was a kid, you know, I used to get those like orange creamsicles all the time, but they also used to get the root beer ones.
Yeah, I would not.
They had the root beer ones, too.
Yeah,
that's
I know.
Why, that's
I
why,
saw those.
Yeah, they were, that's why I love those. They were tight. I used to love root beer dandy.
I love root beer. Love it.
Boone is here!
Chief says, Frozen Yoo-Hoo was one of my childhood... Dude, Frozen Yoo-Hoo, that sounds sick.
So good, dude. I've never had that.
I love Yoo-Hoo.
Dude, you know, they used to have Yoo-Hoo banana, they used to have Yoo-Hoo mint.
Strawberry?
Strawberry, really?
Was there a Yoo-Hoo strawberry?
I don't know.
Strawberry milk.
Well, there's strawberry milk.
Yeah, there's strawberry milk, wasn't there?
That was Nesquik.
I know there's a banana one for sure. You showed me. I never knew there was a banana one.
Well, chocolate banana.
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
It was yellow, though, right?
No, that's the banana in Germany. I got that banana.
That weird banana drink?
It was not weird. It was amazing. It was amazing.
Yeah, I don't know if I like that one.
Yeah, well, you know who liked it? Me and Nick.
Well, Nick's fucking English and likes triangle sandwiches.
I do, too.
Yeah, they're all right.
I bet I make you a triangle sandwich you'd love.
Well, there's
you know,
nothing
really
not to love about triangle
you know,
sandwiches.
You know what? A really simple... you guys want to know... when you guys don't know what else you got in your fridge, a really good simple sandwich to do is... you get mayonnaise, pickle, and cheese. Just the mayonnaise, pickle, and cheese. Swedish style.
That's good.
It's really good. Nice little snack. I do that a lot. I got that one of my ex-girlfriends used to make those all the time because she was reading The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo.
Oh, yeah.
And apparently, I guess it's in Sweden or something in that book.
Yeah, that's where it's set, right?
Right, and that's like a Swedish thing. She like the heroine character, the girl character, who's the star, the protagonist. She apparently eats these little pickle and cheese sandwiches all the time.
Nice.
And
but there's nothing really in there. It's a good call.
Yeah, but see, I like pickles. And I can get the... It's like, yeah, pickle or lettuce, whatever your preference is.
Hold the pickle.
The lettuce has the crunch, and the pickle has the crunch.
You need a crunch in that. That's why I put those radishes in your little tacos I made you that one night. Because sometimes...
Boom.
You just need a crunch. You need that crunch.
Kimmy says strawberry fire... Strawberry milk is fire, TBH.
Strawberry
this is true.
Milk is fire.
I love it. Zach Trent says, hi, Boone. Boone says, hey, everyone, want to grab lunch, but they put an overhead bridge. Too lazy for that. Can't jaywalk no more. Banana milk is underrated. Yeah, I love banana milk. Zach Trent says, Ricky's a fucking beast. Yeah. Watch me do another one.
One more, right?
Yeah, another
one.
Let me
heat up your...
Guys, also, the fucking Mothman pin, dude. The Mothman pin, man. Come on, man. The fucking Mothman pin, dude. It's fucking sick. You know, I'm actually going to be sending a lot of these... to the Mothman Museum in Point Pleasant.
Mm-hmm.
So they're gonna run out pretty fast. You
gotta send one to Art Bell.
This is like the one that like I'm gonna wear the most because it's not only it's a design that I did, but it's not like art. It's like I designed it in like a design true sense. This is like a vectored image of a picture of a Japanese toy replica of the original Mothman sketch.
Hmm.
So it's like many layers. Like it begins with a Mothman sketch,
mm-hmm.
but then in like the 90s, some Japanese toy company made some toy replicas that look like this of the original sketch.
Very good.
And then I got that image from a picture on the internet, and then I took that picture and made it into a pin.
Nice.
But it's just the original sketch, pretty much. But
nice.
It's, this one, because the other one's my artwork, and like I wear my dog one a lot. For sure. I wear all my own pins. But this is like the one that I want to wear all the time because it's like, it's really cool and it's like, I don't know, it's really unique. And I really think Mothman's really cool. And it's, I don't know. Yeah.
Cool. Isaac says, what is Wally World? Oh, Wally World, that's my dad's special place. It's kind of like Margaritaville, you know, when you're at work and you hate it and you get off work and you go home and put on that Jimmy Buffett and you get transported away to a magical place where you don't have to work or worry about schedules or anything. That's what Wally World is to my dad. It's not a place, it's a happy state of mind.
Dale Boone says, saw the pin, never heard of Mothman ever. You should look it up, man. You should really read the book. It was a New York Times bestseller. It came out in 1975. I guarantee you it'll blow your mind. It is the most mind-blowing of all. To me, it's like beyond, levels beyond more fascinating than UFOs. And just as interesting, if not more, than Sasquatch. But also, it incorporates all of that. And unlike UFOs and Sasquatch, where people see them all the time and in intermittent places, Mothman is really famous because... The major, pretty much the only really credible Mothman sightings happened for 1 year in one town in West Virginia with a bunch of, like, really normal people, and, like, something definitely happened.
Something happened there.
And, it like, that's the thing. It's, like, it's something definitely happened. It's just what is it. Mothman's not easy to pinpoint or understand. It has a lot to do with, like, dimensions and, like, kind of how humans have a limited understanding of, like, what is the fabric of reality. Dwangle says, late. What up, Dwangle?
What?
Chief says, you guys still have that red tour van?
Nope.
Fuck no.
I wish.
We don't have.
Sick.
We had another van, then we don't have that van anymore.
Yeah.
Rocky says, your dad's Facebook page is great, by the way.
Cool. I should follow it.
Isaac says, yo, Dwangle, sup. Dwangle says, sup, fam jammers. Taylor says, some love for Nessie? I like this monster to me for sure, but,
It's not, like, so convincing, though. I mean, there's some good...
But I feel like that shit was, like... By the time Loch Ness Monster got popular, she was already dead.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
That makes sense.
There was a plesiosaur. I believe that there are plesiosaurs around. And, there's one in Lake Champlain, or there was.
Yeah.
Champy. And they're plesiosaurs. Mm-hmm. And I think some of them did survive, weirdly, and, like, they're rare. and something about like the, just the way that they do. But I think that Nessie, Loch Ness, did have, you know, Jimmy Page. He's really into the occult,
mm-hmm.
and he's pretty much a Satanist,
he loves
like
the
myself.
Black me dubs, the black.
I want to delve even deeper in that stuff, but I'm a little scared. I need a little bit more. I need somebody to give me a little tips of like what to be careful of before I start like totally delving in. But Jimmy Page has a house on Loch Ness.
Really?
Yeah.
I had no idea.
Yeah.
That's in England, right?
Yeah, and Jimmy Page also, Brian Jones died. At his house, I think. But but John Bonham died at Jimmy Page's house.
Oh wow, I had no idea.
Yeah. Jimmy Page had a bunch of houses. But yeah, Loch Ness, I think there was definitely a what do you call it? A plesiosaur there.
Plesiosaur, yeah.
But I think it's gone now. Who says Pooh Bigfoot? Yeah, I'm from the Pacific Northwest, and I'm gonna go as far as to say to you that I believe in Sasquatch like a nut believes in Jesus. Like it's like if something happened to like to expose to me that there was like no Sasquatch beyond any doubt, I would like have a mental tweak and I don't know, like maybe kill myself or something. It was so a part of like my belief of like nature and like and evolution. And like magic and about how like and simulation and everything that like if I found out that the Sasquatch for sure wasn't real, I think that I would enter a really insanely deeply depressing part of my life.
Yeah.
It's that deep into me.
Because life would be a little
shitty. Not even just that, but like I grew up in the woods and I mean it's the same thing with people like I know Jesus at a personal level. Like I guess that's the same thing, but I don't know Bigfoot on a personal level, but I've had weird shit happening in the woods.
Yeah.
That has made me be like, you know, and my interest hasn't grown. Like I'm not obsessed with that stuff, but it's always maintained. I've always been into Sasquatch. Let's see. Chief says, "Hob shit might be." You guys ever seen the movie The Stoned Age?
Hell
getting
yeah.
A car like that. That movie's awesome, dude.
My favorite line from that shit part, my use of the F word, but he says, "Every band puts out a pussy song just so they could see who the faggots are." And that's because he put on Blue Oyster Cult, Don't Fear the Reaper, and he called it a pussy song, and then took the H-track and threw it out the plug.
Blue Oyster Cult is one of the coolest bands of all time, dude.
Yeah, but that was their pussy song. That was his whole point.
Yeah, the whole point of that movie is that guy's wrong.
Yeah.
The whole point of that movie is
they're
that
all,
guy...
The only
but the
one that's wrong
the
is...
The redhead fool
is... He's the only right one.
And he's the one who likes that song.
Yeah.
And it's not a pussy song.
No.
That's because... Minuteman worship Blue Oyster Cult because Blue Oyster Cult is one of the greatest bands to ever do it. Their band name,
yeah,
everything
Cult.
About Blue Oyster Cult is amazing. They were like joking. They're like a funnier, more like hotter like Steely Dan, but like in a heavier musically direction. But like they're like on some like weird like not like stupid Steely Dan, like early Steely Dan when you think of like dark humor and like so like that, like you know what I mean, like
mm-hmm.
and like a business. Like they're like all, like we sing about like being in an industry,
yeah,
or whatever. Like and like Blue Oyster Cult like broke the fourth wall. You
yeah.
I mean? Like, and their band name, even like Blue Oyster Cult, like a joke, like
uh-huh.
the Blue Oyster Cult.
Yeah.
Like.
Yeah.
And back at the time too, like right after Charles Manson murders, like you know what I mean, like and they were like our band's like Blue Oyster Cult.
Mm-hmm.
It's just sick fucking band name. And that's like Don't Fear the Reaper.
That's
you know what it's about, right?
Huh.
You know what that song's about?
Hmm.
It's about a guy like convincing like his girlfriend to like commit suicide together.
Oh wow.
You know that.
Don't
like,
fear the Reaper.
Like, it will be able to fly. Like, we can be like they are. The whole
yeah.
thing. It's a funny song. It's, like, funny. But it's, like, beautiful. Here it is, like, the thing is, like, in the Stone Age, it's, like, oh, it's a pussy song. But actually, that song, it's like a mistress song. So, like, it's, like, a joke.
Yeah, totally.
About, like Romeo and Juliet style. Like, let's kill each other. Or let's kill ourselves together. And, like, and then we can really be together forever.
Yeah.
Like, that's what it's about. Like.
Awesome.
Yeah, it's sick. Dude, Don't Fear the Reaper is so tight.
That song ribs.
But it's a snot rag. Chief says, ha ha ha, Kalugi on him. The Snapster.
Ding.
Yeah,
the Snapster.
Yeah. The Snapster. Ding. Yes. Oh, man.
Dude,
I love
that shit makes me hork, dude.
Yeah. That shit makes me hork.
Dude, I'm hungry. There's probably a burrito back there in the back seat somewhere.
Like, the guy's gonna come take the girl? Like, this is our girl in here.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Such ridiculous, like,
chicks?
Chicks? Jordan says, Ricky, do you know about soft white underbelly? That sounds really familiar. Is it a... What is it? Give me a hint. I'm gonna do a strikeout while you guys give me a hand. I owe another one.
Yes, you do.
Alright, so torch me up.
Yeah, pass the bottle.
Come on, Isaac, light my fire. I like that old man's cock and balls. How's that? He just sitting on my dick because I'm gay.
Do you have your butane, my dude?
Yeah, that's on the table. Chief says, ha, OX 45 tall cans. What's OX?
They're tall cans, dude.
Oh, okay, yeah. What's your tall can about? I'm just sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Jordan says it's a BOC's original name. Oh, it's BOC, Blue Oyster Cult.
Yeah, it's right here, fool.
Original name. But they used to play secret shows under the name. Whoa, cool. Soft White Underbelly. That was BOC's, Blue Oyster Cult's secret band name.
Before?
Or like, I guess after they got big, they used to play secret shows under that name.
That's tight.
That's so cool. That's such a cool look. Such a cool idea. Oh, man.
Green Day does that sometimes.
What's their band name, though?
I think they just go. They just show up and do it.
Yeah, but see, they would play under. Where you out of here? That's it, huh? You just hit it and quit it, huh? Where are you going? Oh, at the apartment. Nice, dude. Say hi to everybody for me, please.
Ready?
One of my best friends over there, Jaw Wobble, he's going over to some of my other best friends in town's house and to play poker, and you know what? I wish I could go and play. I never played poker before in my life. You guys know that?
I like poker.
Oh, I didn't even get the dab ready, sorry. But. Hold on, sorry. Guys, isn't that crazy? I don't know how to play poker. I don't know how to drive. I don't know how to play poker.
I don't know how to play poker.
You don't know either? Let's learn.
It's not hard.
Oh,
Avalon,
next week, after we get back from desktop, let's do our Sculpey Day. And while we're waiting for it to cook, we can play poker. What? Oh, then we can do it after we get back from Europe. Yeah. Sculpey will stay, right? Or you go back to Seattle just for the visit, not to move back.
You're moving back to Seattle? Go back then. Fucking.
I was like, dude, I want to have an intervention with you right now. Bitch, we need to talk. I want to make you smoke a cigarette with me and sit down. And you're not going to Seattle, fool.
I would not do that.
This is Los Angeles. Don't go move back to Seattle, fool.
Here, hurry up. Let's do this.
Alright, yeah, I'm ready,
sir.
She's talking about moving back to Seattle and shit, dude. I'm like. Out,
all right, here's another strikeout. Isaac says, look in the sky and you'll see that I'm soaring. My name is Soaring. I'm so soaring. Chrissy's here. What's up, Chrissy? She says, hi, guys. And then Isaac says, so do you use Uber, Ricky? Since you don't drive, I think is what he is insinuating. Beautiful.
You're insinuating that I go places. Or don't.
There you go. Jordan says, my uncle saw a sign for a show that said Soft White Underbelly, so we walked in and it was Blue Oyster Cult! At the height of their popularity, that's sick!
Ugh. But the album says, the Vegas sound like everyone in LA has to learn how to drive. I do, in a weird way, I do know how to drive, and that's what I need to procure rides. That's kind of like driving.
It's not, but.
I would be a bomb-ass driver, though, by the way.
Yeah.
I've been also, like, kind of like backseat driving for so long now that, like, I pretty much know the rules.
Yeah, backseat driving is the worst.
Except the like, what was it yesterday, the day before, where you almost crashed and I saved
us? That's not backseat driving. Backseat driving is Go slower, dude. Well, you should have turned there.
You should do this.
Hey, man, watch. Yeah, I'm not saying you do that, but that's what backseat driving is.
I don't really do that. The only times I ever really do that
whoever,
is like,
yeah.
I was doing that a little bit in the Corey on the tour because he was not driving very well.
That's true.
Yeah, that's the only time I ever did that. And that was backseat driving, but like...
It's one thing to be like, whoa! You know, like, that's not backseat
driving.
Also, that's
my
like,
thing, too, is like, it would be like... That's no, not nobody would say anything to Corey while we were driving, and everybody would, like, when Corey was away, everybody would be like, Corey's such a bad driver. But everybody's sitting in the car, and I was like, I don't play that shit. I'm gonna actually say some shit.
Everybody else
wasn't saying anything, but everybody else wanted to complain behind his back about how he wasn't a good driver.
I didn't complain behind his back.
Not you.
I like to let the driver drive, bro. Let the driver drive. He might suck, but that's what we hired him for.
We didn't crash. We didn't get pulled over.
No. He was actually great. And the only time he would fuck up, I mean, he'd fuck up.
In the city.
But he would fuck up. The most of the times when he'd fuck up is when everyone's telling him what to fucking do. When four different people are telling Corey how he should be getting to this place, that's when he fucks up. When he's just doing his own thing, like,
No. He
might make a wrong turn, he might make a stupid move, but
Isaac,
like...
you're trying to make a point about something that isn't true. No, because, after we even laid off on him, dude, he kept fucking up getting on the freeway. He kept fucking up. There was nothing about anybody telling him anything.
But it doesn't... He fucked up just as many times.
Yeah. He fucked up just as many times.
But it's worse if he's gonna fuck up and then everyone's gonna get on him for fucking up. It's just gonna be worse.
Well, we didn't, though.
Well,
and then he just kept fucking up and he just gave up. You remember that tour?
Yeah, I remember the tour. I remember Corey being fine most of the time. He would do one bonehead thing a day, maybe. But, like, he drove fine to me.
Isaac's mad about Corey being a good driver.
He was a great driver.
He was not.
He was an okay driver. We didn't get into any accidents.
The best driver that I know is Nick Webb. And Alex, no, scratch that.
I like Danny more than Nick Webb.
Alex Garcia is the best driver of all time.
Alex is really good.
That's the best driver that ever did it.
I'm not saying that Corey wasn't a fucking idiot. Because he would do some bonehead
stuff.
Hey,
I wasn't calling them any names.
I am.
Okay, well, now...
You're making me feel like I shouldn't defend him for totally driving that entire tour.
No. What about it? Isaac, we paid him.
I know.
And he didn't do that good of a job.
He did.
He did an okay job.
He did a fine job. He did the job. Yeah. He didn't do exceptional, but he did the job.
Corey, you watch right now. What do you think? What would you rate yourself as? I'd say you did about like a C plus. Like you're like a little bit like you're like average, but like the topper tier of average.
I just feel for people who drive. That's all I'm saying.
See, I think Isaac's mad that I don't drive.
No, it's not about that. Yeah.
He's mad that I can't drive in Texas. Because I would go so fast.
I don't drive.
He knows that if I drove really fast in Texas, he would have so much fun. It'd be like a roller coaster.
I don't drive.
And he wishes it so bad Isaac wishes so bad that I could just get behind the wheel and plug that shit up to like 90, 100, and just go up and down the hills every day.
I don't like that.
No,
I would
you
be
would
like, he's the worst driver.
No, I'm not.
I don't like that shit.
No, you would love it.
We already talked about what kind of drivers we like.
I like drivers that listen to good music and smoke weed.
Yeah. Well, the good...
See, that's my thing. It's like, you know what I've learned on the European tour is that my place belongs next to Nick.
Yeah.
I learned that last tour.
Yeah.
Is that, like, I'm supposed to sit up there with Nick and kick it with him. And, and like, me and you kind of swap that. Like, you and him have the cigarette thing, and then me and him also have the, like...
I don't think I sat in front that whole tour, though.
I sat in front a lot the last tour. The Peter Schmidt band.
Or, no, in Europe, the last Europe tour, I don't think I sat up front.
I sat up front the whole second half.
Well, usually when we do a tour, everyone has their spots.
Crazy says, Texas in the house. My homie Lucas Gorham is your homie, too. Hell yeah, Lucas is my dog. He plays not just my homie. He's in my band, The Memories. I pay him to be my band. Tailbone says, guys, I am still learning to ride a bicycle.
There you go.
Dude, bikes are fun, right?
Bikes are good.
Bikes for me, though, are like second nature. Like, dude, like, I hadn't ridden a bike in like 3 years, and I got one, and the first thing I did is I just rode to Jimmy's house, and it was like...
Well, that's where that saying comes from.
Right.
It's like riding a bike.
Yeah, you just already know. You just know. And also, L.A. seems like a really cool place to ride a bike. Just make sure you wear your helmet, and also just like know that every time, even when you step out your house with your foot, just know that like you're taking a risk. And the more fun you have, the more risks you're having. But like, you know, I think that I hyped myself up pretty hard, thinking that LA was not going to be a good city to bicycle in. And then to find that now that I actually rode like down even just a little tiny bit, that it was like, dude, this is fine. The only problem is that like I have to ride on the sidewalks a lot. It's like reminds me of like when I was a kid, Jimmy. Remember me with Notch for a second? Yeah. Chief says, best Stone Age quote is when they are trying to trade the Schnappster for some fine chicks, and it says, it, and say, it will get six fat chicks all Wilden Holden style fucked up. Isaac's corner says, yo, what's up? What up, Isaac? What? You still here?
Yeah, what are you talking about? Yeah, you've been here.
You've been here, dog.
Been here,
Chris says, he kept my rent and sent me...
Oh, he says, what's up to Margot?
Oh, hell yeah. Margot.
Sorry,
he kept my rent and stumpy for VHS for like 18 years. Got to back, and that's a win for me. Hell yeah.
That sounds like something Lucas would do.
Chalboon says, sup, Morgoth. Morgoth says, sup, Boontoon. Oh, shit, Stimpy? Fuck you, autocorrect. Chalboon says, trying my best to get the cash for LA this month. All right, we got 19 watching, 16 likes, and what's our, we're only at $80. We haven't even broke 100 yet. This is fucked up.
It's pretty fucked
up. I'm going to break some shit.
Just break everything. Fuck it. I don't care.
I'm starting to get my lung capacity, but last night I smoked so many cigarettes.
That's what happens. You know, when you're all drunk and shit, smoking cigarettes are nice.
I never got drunk, though. I was drinking coffee the whole entire time.
Uh-huh.
But then I was like, I did like a shot after like my first song I finished with Fungal, which was like an hour and a half in. And then I slowly was getting shots from there. But by the time that I finished, I probably drank close to a fifth. Last night, but I was like till 5 in the morning working,
yeah,
like doing really good.
Yeah.
But then only this morning I woke up and I was kind of like, oh, I kind of like don't remember a lot of that, but like it sounds amazing. I killed
it. Yeah, you did. If you can't remember, it sounds like you're drunk. You got drunk. Doesn't mean you didn't do good work though.
Yeah, I definitely got drunk. Yeah, but I never was like, while I was there, I was never like,
well, because you're working. You're, like, focused.
Well, not just that, but I was never, like, drunking around.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
You're working.
But, like, but then after, it was, like, a slow burner drunk. Like, it was, like, like, a day drunk. It was a night drunk. Like, I was, instead of, like, 10 a.m. to, like, 5 p.m., it was, like, 10 p.m. to, like, 5 a.m.
Yeah.
That was, like, it was a night drunk, like, slow, like, not getting wasted, but, like, definitely, like, tweaked.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Plus the coffee.
Oh, yeah. I felt like I was on drugs. Morgan says, I believe in you, Boone. Bree says, I got destroyed by mosquitoes the other night and I'm dying slowly. I don't want you to die.
You're not dying. Unless you have malaria, then maybe.
Oh, nice. We got a sweet little downvote.
Hell yeah. We had like 3 the other night. It was sick.
And then they flip back up.
You know? Sometimes people just do that.
Nice.
They take back the down and we're like, actually, we do like this.
All right, guys. I want to try to get to 10 strikeouts. Can we do this? I've done 3.
3. So far, yeah.
Maybe not 10. Can we do 5? I did 10 the other night, dude. That should have fucked up me.
It'd been fucked up if you trying to talk about it. What? It's like you had a PTSD. Like,
oh,
flashback.
Man, that shit was fucked. Yeah, I got really fucked up last, what was that? Last Wednesday?
That was last Wednesday, right? That was when Alex came.
The countdown, 10 strikeout countdown.
Yeah, that was last Thursday. That was on this, yeah. So that was last Narte Final Life for sure.
Aim for the sky, Ricky. Well, I'll do as many strikeouts as you guys send me. I'll do 20 if you send me 20.
There you go.
Sartorius is here! Welcome, Sartorius. Dude, we got the Mothman pins, and I gotta say, these are my favorite ones that I've ever done. They're so cool. They're also, like, the biggest.
They also look delicious. Yeah.
It looks cool. It doesn't look scary. He does actually
look delicious.
Legit, though, like, he doesn't look scary like this small, but like that fool was like 8 feet tall. So that's scary as fuck.
Yeah. Dude, if that was 2 feet tall, I would be like, what the fuck is that?
It looks so much like what I saw in the woods when I was a kid that day, but it was all white when I saw.
Weird.
With black eyes.
Huh.
I've always thought it was an owl, but then like whenever I look back at it, I was like, well, that was like, it had to be my size.
Yeah.
That was like 4 feet tall.
Yeah.
So I don't know what that was. It looked like a monkey, too. Oh, let's see. Sartorius says, can't wait for that Mothman pin. Yeah, it's already here, buddy. Sartorius says, hey, Boone, Brie Baked.
Very good. We got the fam. We got the fam. giving their intros and their introduction. And,
let's get some more sales in there.
Yeah, let's get some more sales in there, but how about everyone go to nartapes.com/GTG? I want to smoke some weed. How about someone donate for a joint or something? Or dabs. A pair of dabs. Or something, I don't know. I want to smoke some weed. That's where I'm coming from.
10:28. Alright, we're still got an hour and a half left. Damn. I got plenty of time to do these strikeouts.
Mm-hmm.
Ha! Let's see. That's not one.
Somebody get Azagada, somebody get Azagada, somebody get Azagada, somebody get Azagada,
Somebody get.
Very good.
That's not the right song either. Where's the part? I love it when you buy something. Buy something good like the Mothman pin or the legalized shirt. I don't know where to begin. If you want to get one or get two or three, go to nartapes.com/GTG. That's where you get the shit I'm improvising. And if you want a shirt, I got some advisements. You can get the Nartapes Network. You can get the vote free weed. Yeah, me and Isaac hanging out in the... Guess what? Yeah. Oh, wait. It's a...
I love it when you buy something. Guess what? I love it when you buy something. Guess what?
Yeah, Zach Schrapp.
Guess what?
That's for you.
Yes, for me. Hell yeah, Zach. That's my dog. You know Zach? One time when we lived in Portland. When we lived in Portland one year when we went on tour, Zach Schrapp subletted my room. And when we got back, the people in the house, like we moved, I got back into my room and Zach moved out or whatever. And the people in my house were like, damn, we heard Zach banging his girlfriend all the time.
I heard Zach banging all the time, dude.
And I was like, damn. So I'm like,
not Zach, but like,
And then
maybe it was Zach.
And then I was like, damn, is that what it sounds like when I be banging in my room? Everyone in the fucking house can hear it. I wasn't ready for that shit. Can you hear me? Thank you, bud. Dude, Zach's tight. Zach's my dog.
All right, guys, give me more strikeouts. We got 17 likes, 21 watching. Smash that like button.
Oh, hell yeah.
Hey. It's my favorite song to rap on. It's Skinny Jesus and I got my drags on. It's Nartapes, not live GTG. What's up with y'all? My family is the Donation Nation. Up in the house, if you give us $5, yeah, I'll take another shout out. Then we'll do that thing. I'll I'll drink my beer. We'll hang out more. I'll say it clear. He's rapping, doing the thing. Got Ricky, Jimmy, Avalon, and Bunny. All the Nartakes Network at Studio G. Why don't you donate for me? $5 gets you a shot. $5 gets you a shot of beer. Shotgun to beer. Shotgun to joint. Smoking that shit. Then I'm in my point. Go to the website, nartakes.com/GTG. Get some shit for me. Get some shit for Ricky. Get some shit for Jimmy. Avalone in the house and we're doing it quickly. It's Wednesday night, so you know how we doing it. What the fuck? Yeah, I'm proving it. It's Wednesday. Let me get my shit. Why don't you put a donation and get it quick? Trying to get fucked up here. Got a lot of shit to do. I don't even care. I'ma get drunk for y'all in here. Nartakes.com/GTG. Beer. Yeah. Hey. Tail Boone says, Singha, it's honestly great. Singha's nice. Sartori says, that food is on another level. I don't know what you're talking about. Zach says, haha, I was a freak back then.
Sartori says, prob the beer too. We give it and says, that's what happens when you have roommates. Tail Boone says, Ricky, just sample those banging sounds. That's the fireworks.
Yeah, it's 4th of July. Sartori
says, skinny Jesus.
That's me.
Morgoth says, I'm going to try that Singha beer, Boone. Hopefully I can find it here. Sartori says, get it. You
go to Bembo.
Never at Singha?
Go to Bevmo, dude. They got everything at Bevmo. Come on.
That's not what I thought it was.
Sartori says, get it.
Oh, this one. This one's one of the good ones.
Golden creature. Sartori says, I want to hear a totally you free weed split tape. Zach Schrat says, Chang is dope too with the elephants. Chang. Yeah, the Chang's nice. Margot says, yeah, it looks really classy and cool. And Tail Boone says, no, dude, roommates banging. Yeah, you know, in that house. Room in our house, an attic room, there was no insulation. And you could just hear everything that went up in that room and every room pretty much. So you know that, you know? They
yeah.
Hear stuff. Says this sounds like some Halloween shit. He makes us what up, Morgoth? Morgoth says she bangs. Sup, Bree? All right, y'all. What's up?
Please give us a marijuana and something to smoke and something to drink. Please give us a marijuana and something to smoke and something to drink. Please give us a marijuana and something to smoke and something to drink. Please give us a marijuana and something to smoke and something to drink. Please give us a marijuana and something to smoke and something to drink. Please give us a marijuana and something to smoke and something to drink.
Here you go. Tamir Lee says, so y'all band together, live stream together, and live together. Damn. We're like,
something to smoke and something to drink. Please give us a marijuana and something to smoke.
Yeah. We're like proof that communism works on a very small scale. Morgoth says, yeah, I got my legs. with mosquito bites. Damn, mosquito bites are whack. Jordan says, Ricky, you are finally playing my favorite song. DMT. Kimberly says, not pooping fireworks. LOL. I know what you meant. Pooping is just funner. Chrissy Manis says, what happened to your butt? Not my butt. Just like the proverbial butt.
Huh?
Do anything
in the letter part. Not yet, no. I can't focus on that food stuff yet. I need to drink strikeouts, guys. No, you can go get some food.
Couple tacos.
21 watching, 19 likes.
Rubik
what
says,
the fuck was that bug?
See, that's what I don't like. I've seen rats. I've seen
what
mice.
What was that?
I've seen cockroaches. But it's these little other bugs that I've never
seen
before.
I don't even know what the fuck that was.
Yeah, I don't. That's what I don't like. I don't like these mystery new bugs. Like, is our place, like,
where's
where the
Dane?
New bugs come? He's at the place.
He's still there?
I don't. He hasn't hit me up. Yeah.
Maybe Jimmy and a few, you maybe just drive up there because he's probably almost done. It's just the one up there by that crossing Jack in the Box. And just see what's up with him. He's probably either almost done, and if he's not, then something's wrong. He should have been done like an hour ago, I feel like. No, yeah, but we had a plan. I don't know, let's see, maybe there was a wait or something. I don't know what's going on, but.
Well, they have Wi-Fi. He wouldn't call. I guess that's the whole thing. Maybe just text him. Rebake says, my butt lives its own life. All right. Morgoth says, what in the butt? Kimberly says, LOL, Bree. Chrissy also says, it was a great line. I loved it. Chief says, how's girlfriend? She there?
Yeah, where is she? Go, friend!
Dude.
Get it. Get it. How about that, Chief? His girlfriend, girlfriend dog. She's fucking cool, she fucking rocks. His girlfriend, girlfriend dog. Well, laundry takes a long time sometimes.
Where's my microphone then?
It's dead. See what I've been lost?
I haven't seen it in a while, actually. No.
I did it. The last time I used it, I put it back on your stand. Or the last time we used it was on the show last time.
Yeah, but I haven't seen it in a while. Well, you see if it's in the other room. Right, Sartorius, you want to see me and Isaac battle rap? Then you have to pay at least $20. At least! No, I want 30 because it's like $10 each song, like a song request. But then like it's like $5 each more, like $10 more for it to be a battle. I think 30 is fair. I need the cable.
Where is it?
No, it's not in one of those ones. It is a direct. Guys, I want to do another strike out. Strike me out, Daddy. Strike me out. Strike three.
It's not this one. Not this one.
That one.
This one you want?
Yeah. Oh, the, no.
Yeah,
that's
right?
The one. That's mine.
Yeah. It was attached. It was attached to that.
Okay. But I there's another one that's supposed to be just like a small. Male to female. Oh! Sartre says, do it for free? Man, what the fuck? Oh, free weed? Ha! Ha, yeah! Nah, man, I'm not gonna do it for free, though. Okay. Kimmy says, okay, I'm out, y'all. Work in the morning. Pump inside, little pookie butt. What happened to your butt? McGraw says, buy a little beer, have a good morning. Chrissy's been the best freestyle ever. It made me laugh so hard.
Very good.
Yes. My dad. I always tell my dad he can't tell me what to do. But when he's sick of my dad, I always tell me he's the one who's gonna tell me what to do. My dad always telling me the things that I don't want to hear, not now. Not now, Dad. My dad always telling me some bullshit in my ear, I don't need that shit now. No, Dad. What? How do you know that song, fool? Dad came home from his hunting trip. That's a free old. That's one of the first freebie songs.
You have fans, bro.
Daddy might not come home from his hunting trip, and Daddy.
You got fans, bro.
But nice. So just I'm your dad. Damn, Sartorius is aggressive tonight.
Dude, he's drinking.
He's probably drunk. Yeah.
He's drank.
Let's see what else beats we got in here.
He's drank.
That's right, I'm your dad. If I had another choice, I would've let the condom in the bag. Put the condom on, I am now not your dad. Dad, dad, I'm the dad.
Put it in the bag.
Damn, our last sale was 15 minutes ago. This sucks. I feel like we're going to desktop tomorrow.
Stay there. And we are going to desktop tomorrow.
I'm the one in the motherfucking son of a gun. I come and beat up on your baby's butt. Hey, come on, go to my website and get a motherfucking pen of tape tonight. Yeah, come on, it's us in Los Angeles. And if you don't hear me, then you can handle us. Yeah, I'ma do another strikeout. Guess what? There ain't no doubt. I need another sale from y'all, and if you do this, huh?
You gonna pick up Dane? To me, that shit is fucking insane. Doing my goddamn thing tonight. I feel fucking mother wrong, alright. Yeah, got eyes act to the right of me. I'm feeling like I gotta poop again. Yeah, I'm going up to Highland Park after dark, and then I'm gonna get a shark. Yeah, I'm getting pretty drunk. What you stuck? I'm gonna pump it down my butt.
There you go. Hey, come on, guys. I'm gonna battle rap Isaac for $30. 20 bucks.
30 or 20? Hello, Rutherford! It's been a while since I've seen you! Rutherford!
That's so quiet.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, dude.
Zach Strath said, did you do that dab yet, Isaac? I did. I thought you were watching. Yeah, I said, this is for you, Zach. And I did that damn dab. I did it.
Yeah,
what's up?
Yeah, dude.
Free Bake says, I like Ricky hair blowing in the wind. Ricky's hair blowing in the wind. Sartori says, I'm going to buy a Narstock pin if you have a battle rap. We'll buy the pin and then we'll see what happens.
That's a rip-off to me. We haven't even made it to 100 bucks yet.
There you go. Then we're not going to do it.
Man, that's disappointing. I'm disappointed in myself. I'm just kidding.
Don't diss up tequila. And if you drink it like me, it'll kill ya. They call this up.
All right, you want to preview and see if I'm the right beat? See, I want to find the right beat. Not that one. No, that one. Not that one. Not that one. Not that one. No.
Zach says, that's cool. That little Donnie was gonna play Death Stock. Nice. Pretty cool.
Okay.
As that thing sees tough, but he ain't shit, cause I do the goddamn strikeouts around here. Yeah, cause he sits down and I stand up, and every time he does, I touch his little butt. He's about 3'9" compared to me, and I don't ever wait, and I don't scream in the league. He's a little boy, I'ma touch his nuts, and be ever just a step up to me. There we are. The hardest thing that you ever seen is when I do a dab shot and a shotgun. But if you want me to rap to Isaac, guess what, they ain't fucking turning back. Cause I will fucking break our friendship right now. I don't wanna be your friend anymore, you bitch.
We're battling, bro.
I'm gonna fucking kill this dude with a knife, and then I'm gonna go and take
hey,
his little wife. I'm gonna fucking kill Isaac in front of me, and then I'm gonna go and take his girlfriend, baby, and then I'm gonna go and fucking kill myself just to prove to Isaac that I'm the bell.
There you go. That's a nice little preview, then.
I need a dab, a shot, a strike out.
Freestyle doesn't mean it's free, bro. It's not free. My life was, I don't care who you do.
I didn't ask me. Do you want me to hear dab? The word dab? The word shot? The word shotgun? Or the word strikeout?
I'm a damn shot.
I want Ima and Anna. Ima and Anna.
This dog kicks ass. All right. All right, guys. Can we get some more sales now, please? That was fucked up. All right, cool. Oh, there we go. We're done. All right, guys. So what we got? We have 13 watching now and 19 likes. Damn, we lost everybody.
Yeah. Well, you know, I don't know.
We still have an hour left.
Your phone work?
Oh, I was hanging out over there.
It was cool.
I love your mask.
He was like asking for Wi-Fi.
They kick it.
Yeah, I basically just kicked it.
Did you get free dryer?
It starts at 10, right? Or 11.
11. Chris says, oh shit, that was great. Thank you.
Tonight is free dryer night.
All right, we got 20 likes, thank God. All right, so are we going to make any more sales? What do you guys want us to see us do? I will do another strikeout. I'll give you guys a free shot. How about that? I'll boost it. I'll give you guys a little booster, a free booster.
There you go.
I'll do a shot, so now every strikeout is looking at me even more drunk. You know what I'm saying? It's like a booster.
It's a buff. They call that a buff in
like buff.
RPGs. It's like a plus one to attack buff.
All right, guys. So the shot's for you to encourage you to buy. Buy more strikeouts.
This shot's for you and you and you and you.
When we were at the grocery store earlier, the manager was like, "Oh, where's your better half?" I was like, "That's actually his better half." He's like, "Oh." So finally, they don't think that me and Apple are together anymore. I wanted to make some kind of joke about how I have all these girlfriends all over the world, but I don't.
They don't think we're together anymore.
Chief Handkerchief is Drunken Master XP plus Tania.
Because we would go there together
one.
And get groceries.
Guys, a moment of silence while I blow minds real quick, Isaac.
Yeah, blow their minds.
Smell this. Confirm this. Tequila. Just smell it. Confirm it.
I already know.
Confirm.
I hate.
Just confirm.
Yeah, it is. I hate the smell of that shit. I hate the smell of all alcohol. That's why I could never work in a fucking bar. It should make me fucking barf. I hate it. The worst thing to me when we're on tour and shit is like when you have to load in through the back of the bar and then you have to smell all the empty fucking bottles of booze. Ugh! That shit makes me want to fucking barf just thinking about it. I hate it. Make you want a fork? Ding! What happened? What?
She hates me. I'm convinced. They don't like white bulls up there.
They don't like that color hair you have.
They don't like white bulls up there.
Oh man, I really like the food.
They really don't. They didn't like Nikki either. So.
You know what, guys? If we don't make any more sales in a couple minutes, then like, why are we even here, huh? I need to get up early in the morning to go to Deathstalk.
Yeah, I got a bunch of shit to do tonight too. So
we haven't even made it past $100.
I'm down to hang still, but
What do you need from me to make it past $100? This is ridiculous. I gave you strikeouts, got Mothman pins. I'm feeling like a piece of shit! Somebody in the bathroom?
No. Jimmy? Jimmy's taking that. Jimmy's taking one of his trademark Jimmy poops right now.
He said, yeah!
Oh, yeah. Been in there for a while.
He takes long poops?
I do too. I have to let that shit just go. I cannot force that shit. I gotta let that shit just go down on its own accord. Otherwise, I'm gonna fucking hurt myself. So, yeah, guys. Let's get some more strikeouts. Let's see what I have in the beginning of the, let's see what number, 15 is. Nothing. There's nothing on 15.
Nothing on 15, huh?
Nothing on 15.
My name is Jimmy. I poop at night. And when I poop, I like to poop because the poop is right.
Oh, what a coincidence that he's coming out right now. I'm just kidding. Wow, too loud.
I like
Jimmy. It's
pretty loud, bro.
Alright. 14 watching, 21 likes. We're kicking it. I just had a shot.
Yeah.
I'm gonna smoke a cigarette.
Smoke one, dude.
Talk, Isaac. Let's do some sales,
there's
man.
There's nothing like smoking a cig and
I can't do all the strikeouts and all the sales pitches.
You're not doing all the sales pitches, man. I'm doing them too.
Then let's sell some sales.
You know, that's not up to me, man. We've been talking about the Mothman pins all night. The Mothman pins are fucking sick. All you gotta do is go to nartapes.com/GTG. You can pick up a new Nartape or a Mothman pin. We also got the fucking Narstock pins in. Those are limited edition. We're taking those to Deathstock with us this weekend. And, you know, if they're sold out after that, then y'all left out. We always give the Donation Nation, the Nartapes Network crew, we always give y'all first dibs on all the merch. You know what I mean? So grip one of the Mothman pins. Grip one of the Narstock pins. We got a lot of new merchandise up for sale. We
and
got,
nobody's bought my new ice cream dog tape.
Yeah, no one's
the whole stream. Can you go grab one of those next to the cutting board, the pink guys?
Yeah. You got it, Dave.
You know what? You guys remember my monkey... Do you guys remember my Monkey Shines cassette by Freeweed that I did last summer of all my spoken word hilariousness off my phone? I did a sequel, Ice Cream Dog. There's only 48 copies... It's now for sale on the website. It's up there. Funkle said it is.
There we go. Got some right here.
Bam! Look at these beautiful pink tapes. It's exactly the same kind of layout as the last tape I did. It's a series I'm going to be doing. So buy one of these and a strikeout at the same time, and you'll be creating havoc in Los Angeles.
There you go. I like that.
Frog. These tapes are awesome.
Yeah, we also have the new Memories Royal United Song Service LPs. On the site right now, the album came out this past Friday, last week, and it's new, it's fresh, yep. It's a double vinyl, 29 songs, it was really a labor of love for us, and it took us 2 years to make, and we fucking finally finished it, so you can go to the website, nartapes.com/GTG, go get you a Memories Royal United Song Service LP, it comes with a double vinyl, gatefold, little insert with and there's a story to every song. It's really nice. It's right there on the site. And if you use your Nartapes code GTG, you save 10%. Works. So there you go.
All right, I'm gonna drink some of this coffee real fast.
There you go.
Don't tell me how to shit myself.
Oh. Don't tell me.
Actually, I won't mention it wasn't me, but I do know a certain Nart person that admitted to shitting their bed. Fungal. He sharded his bed.
I've never shit my bed, but I've shit my pants a couple times.
There's no more chats either, guys. Smash that like button, please.
I've shit my pants before.
I've never done it. I'm just waiting.
You've never done that?
Fungal said he would show up at some point during the stream, but man, we haven't made a sale in like 16 minutes.
That's a damn shame.
I don't know what kind of bug this is.
That's what I'm saying, fool. That's what I don't like. I don't like these new bugs. Like, it's like Studio G is this place where new bugs, like, evolve and become into... I'm not even joking. We got new bugs over here.
Jesus, Funkle sneeze fart, too.
The sneeze fart?
Did he do that?
Funkle has pooped on the floor accidentally before.
Oh, yeah, that's a good story.
And
like
he shit his bed. He threw his sheets away.
Yeah, I would do. I would burn my bed.
Yeah, like the shit didn't get to the mattress. How are you gonna pretend? How are you gonna pretend like this shit didn't make it to the mattress?
I have the chicken sandwich. And I have crunch fries. I have the chicken sandwich. I have the chicken sandwich. And I have French fries. I have the chicken sandwich. And I have French fries. I have the chicken sandwich. And I have French fries.
I do love that Fumble story where.
What, he was naked and brushing his teeth or some
shit? Brought out one of his sneezes and then pooped it onto the ground.
My mommy beats me.
Morgan says, that's some doo-doo!
My mommy beats me. I beat my mama. My mommy beats me, I beat my mama. My mama beats me, I beat. That's not true, guys. What the real
Sartor says, as long as he didn't shit in bed like the dude in Train Spot.
I need a strikeout. We need some strikeouts.
I
need a strikeout. We need some strikeouts. I need a strikeout. We need some strikeouts. I need a strikeout. We need some strikeouts. I need a strikeout.
I need a strikeout.
We need some strikeouts.
Strikeout.
I need a strikeout.
I need a strikeout.
We need some strikeouts.
Strikeout.
I need a strikeout.
I need a strikeout.
We need some strikeouts.
Strikeout.
I need a strikeout.
I need a strikeout.
We need some strikeouts.
Strikeout.
I need a strikeout.
I need a strikeout.
We need some strikeouts.
I need a strikeout.
I need a strikeout. We need some strikeouts.
Strikeout.
I need a strikeout.
I need a strikeout.
We need some strikeouts.
Strikeout.
I need a strikeout.
I need a strikeout.
We need some strikeouts. I need a strikeout. How's that?
Pretty good. So we made a sale.
What was it?
Two past the medicines.
Oh, got a pack of all. Yeah. Isaac, will you do me a favor, or Dan Jibo? We go to my desk and get the pen or the pipe. On my desk right there in the middle of the room. It's tight. It's a clean article one. Nicholas, a strikeout! Yeah, give me a strikeout, man. I need a strikeout.
Pass the medicine, pass the medicine, pass the medicine, pass it on to me. guys. Well, since Bree left, it's good to know who's still in the chats and watching, because everyone said bye to her. What's up? All right, we out here, guys. Thank you, Chrissy. We're smoking this bowl right now. And it's all thanks to you. So thank you, Chrissy. And I will let Lucas know that you held us down. And could you do me a favor, Chrissy, and text Lucas and tell him he's a fucking square for not coming to Deathstalk. I know he has important shit to do, but he's not coming to Deathstalk, and he's not going to play with the band this weekend. And so there you go. Call his ass, text his ass, and tell him he's a fucking square. Tell him that. On my mama. Isaac says, lit.
I'm innocent! That's what's up, and I love it. Love it when I put it in the budget.
Austin!
Yeah! The first guy to ever buy the Ice Cream Dog tape by Free Weed. You remember Monkey Shines? Oh, man. Ice Cream Dog is, has got so many good songs on it, dude. It's better than Monkey Shines. Yeah. Or as good. It's different. It's like, it's the exact same thing, but it's like, there's like more different stuff happening. The first song was like, da-na-na-na, I'm lost and I can't find my mind. Da-na-na-na, da-na-na-na. Yeah, it's sick.
Yeah,
it's
even like Monkey Shines is good ass music.
Huh?
Monkey Shines is good ass music.
Yeah, well, Ice Cream Dog is a sequel. It's exactly right. The same thing. But just in a different way. Oh, give me a strikeout!
Get the man a strikeout. Hell yeah, Austin, thank you so much for
Why was
it
1083? Is all, is, I don't know. There's something else probably there. There's only one item?
$7-$8 for the tape. Or it's up for $8.
Oh, yeah, because these are rare.
Hell yeah, Austin. So, you know,
you're... Wait, they're up for $8?
Yeah.
Put it up for $5. Change it to $5. They're supposed to be $5. Fungles are $8. Mine are $5. All right, Twiggins, you kind of got fucked up and had to pay $8, so we're going to give Isaac a shot for that. Right?
Yeah, I'm down. I just was, you know, I didn't set the price. I'm
no,
not
no, no,
sure.
It's not you.
Yeah. So $5, right?
Yeah, $5. So
sorry, Dwiggins, you got overcharged, but we're fixing it by me taking a shot. How about that? How about that?
Chrissy says, two bowls, boys, smoke. Yeah, all right, first bowl's almost done.
Yeah, we're finishing up. Hey, Chrissy, did you hear my Lucas spiel? Can you please? I'm just kidding. Don't text him and make him feel bad. But do text him and make him feel bad, because he's missing out on the best weekend of every all time. Dude. When you say dead, you know it's serious. Dead. Jimmy, I gotta tell you something. When we took Dane to the laundromat, this fool's phone was on top of the car the whole way. And it only fell off once we got into the parking lot of the laundromat. And as soon as something dropped,
phone.
And as soon as something he heard something drop, Dane was like, oh my god, my phone. And then we look back.
It drove the whole entire way to the, and then fell off in the parking lot. Dude, damn. You had two times today. Two times today. There are signs from the universe. Pay a little more attention to the important fights.
Thank you, Austin.
The important things in life. Phones. Sausage.
Tighten up, boy.
I told Isaac this before. Isaac, I remember the only time. The worst time I ever saw Isaac untighten. I didn't say, I mean, doesn't say he was loose, but he was untightening a little bit, was our last European tour. Isaac knows what I'm talking about.
That was weird.
It was weird. Isaac was like...
I'm usually like the solid as well dog.
Isaac was fucking up every day, pretty much. Like, every day. Before we even got to Europe. Like, he fucking found hash in his fucking, like, bag, like, in the middle of our flight. Like, path. Like, we were at layover in Seattle, thank God. And when we got to Frankfurt, they shook him down. Thankfully, he found that hash. But Isaac also got us all strip searched. Isaac is the reason we all got strip searched. And he also almost lost his leg. And, like, he was just not on it that tour. He was like, he bounced back pretty good, though.
But like Isaac,
I didn't sleep like that whole week before we left too. That might have that plus like a jet lag.
That's happened to me in Australia.
Well, yeah, that's like, exactly what happened to you. Because I was fine that first week in Australia.
Not me.
But it took you like 2 days to get into the zone. So, you know, yeah, I fucked it up or whatever.
Well, they say like when you get better at tennis, you have to get a little worse first. And then you bounce
back. Is that a pun because of tennis?
Same with Overwatch.
Yeah, but it's more like you excel further.
I would like to steer the any kind of, if anybody out there is like trying to support the Nerd Tapes Network tonight, I would rather you not buy me strikeouts and actually buy
merch.
The new Freeweed tapes.
Or the Mothman pin,
man. Like,
physical merchandise.
Think about that.
Think about the children. Think about all the children. Hell yeah, Enzo's here. What up, Enzo?
Enzo!
I like that.
Smash that like button, guys.
Arturo says, what buildings are behind you? Well, you got the U.S. Bank building, the Wells Fargo building.
Dude, we haven't done any songs or raffles.
Oh. Well, let's do it.
Yeah, we need to do two raffles and three songs.
All right, so first raffle.
Wow. Okay, let's see whose birthday it is.
Chibo, come pick one of these names for me really quick.
Let's see whose birthday it is, guys. I'm lost and I can't find my mind.
I'm Austin. Spencer won the first raffle. He's already getting a bunch of cool shit, so that's nice. He'll get even more shit. All right, so Spencer's out of the next raffle. Dane, one more. One more, my dog. I'm stoked you're coming with us, man.
Come on.
Me too. It's gonna be sick. It's gonna fucking dope. It's gonna be way better
than. Yeah, we're gonna be close.
Avalon! Raffle 2! So you can peruse the selection, Avalon, and you can peruse. And you can pick something out nice that you would like since you won the raffle.
Wow. Have you ever had a live raffle?
No.
Yeah.
Never, ever. It's like supermarket sweep. All right.
Oh, it's 50 Cent's birthday.
Hell yeah. I can do in the club. Let's do that.
It's like tomorrow. Not tonight, but it presses like in 40 works. Minutes.
East Coast, it's already 50's birthday.
So Kate Nash is on this website too. It's her birthday too. Kate Nash. Bill Haley from Bill Haley in the comments. Oh yeah, let's do that. All right, let's do that. Okay.
What?
Oh, my phone can't do it though.
Rock around the clock.
Yeah, my phone's iPhone 7.
No, here. I got my thing.
22 likes, 16 watching. All right, let's do Bill Haley in the comments.
Near Ox. Rock around the clock, right?
Okay. I support that. Aux in. Make sure to turn it down on your phone or your computer.
Less than half right now. Bill Haley. Oh, he does shake, rattle, and roll too. That's cool. Here we go. Alright. It's short too. That's nice.
Let's see who was born today.
One, two, three, clock, rock, five, six, seven, clock, eight o'clock, rock, nine, ten, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock, around the clock tonight.
Oh, look at this cool, you can't see this, but it's literally a couple dancing in the moonlight.
When the time makes 5, 6, 7 is heaven. We'll be right in 7 heaven. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight.
Rock, 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 rock
We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. We're gonna rock, rock, rock till the bright. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight.
Hey!
Hey!
And then you're
doing
this.
My friend!
Rock and roll song,
yeah. My door's got a watch that's chill. Cool up dance. So rock around the clock again. Gonna rock around the clock tonight. Rock, rock, rock to the Friday night. Gonna rock the clock tonight.
The C's look like E's.
Oh, dude! Today, actually, right now, when it's still 11:24, it's Elvis's birthday.
Let's do an Elvis song.
Let's do All Shook Up.
Alright,
karaoke.
Or what about
All Shook Up? I want to do it.
Or Can't Help. I
want to
do Can't Help Falling.
Yeah, but let me do All Shook Up
I
first.
That's fine.
Just look up on the thing. Here we go. I'm gonna do it. Here we go. All. Happy birthday, Elvis!
Is it Elvis' birthday?
It really is Elvis.
We need to text Chevelle. TCB, take care of business, y'all.
Use it. No, it's not Elvis Presley's birthday, but...
Use it. Which Elvis?
It's not Elvis. No, stop it. It's not Elvis' birthday, guys. Sorry, I did like 3-4 strikeouts. It's the guy who wrote I Hear You Knockin'. Who Elvis covered. Sorry, guys. So you can't do Elvis. It's my bad. Oh, it's Huey Lewis's number. All right. It's Huey Lewis's birthday. Let me do, Harder Rock and Roll.
Harder Rock and Roll?
Yeah. All right. Happy birthday, Huey Lewis!
He has a big dick. He has a huge cock.
Turn up a bit.
He does.
Happy birthday, Huey.
Girl,
happy birthday, Huey Lewis.
Lewis.
Happy birthday, bud.
Everyone.
New York is everything they say. No place I'd rather be. What else can you do? Half a million things. Oh, at a quarter to three. When they play the music, ooh, that modern music. They like it with a lot of style. But it's that same old backbeat rhythm that really, really drives them wild. They say the heart of rock and roll is still beating. And from what I've seen, I believe them. Now the old man may be breathing. But the heart of rock and roll, heart of rock and roll is still beating.
Happy birthday, Huey!
LA, Hollywood, and the Sunset Strip. Something everyone should see. Neon lights, and the pretty, pretty girls all dressed so skinnily.
Yeah, boy!
When they play the music, hard rocking music, they like it with a lot of flash. But it's still that same old backbeat rhythm that really, really kicks them in them. They say the heart of rock and roll is still beating. And from what I've seen, I believe them. Now the old world may be barely breathing. But the heart of rock and roll is still beating. Johnny! Happy birthday, Huey! The biggest dick in rock and roll. That dick, he's a nice man. He's the nicest man in rock and roll. The biggest penis in rock and roll. It's a fact. It's
like,
well known.
Like,
and he's super nice. And he's super awesome. For real. I know firsthand.
Yeah.
DC, San Antonio, in the Liberty Town. Boston, and Baton Rouge. Tulsa, Austin, Oklahoma City. Seattle, San Francisco, too. And, well, there's music, real
Wolf.
Oh yeah, let's do
Cassie backing singer with Lynyrd Skynyrd.
Oh, let's do
Robbie Robertson of the band.
Oh, let's
do it. Let's do the way together. Let's do the way together. Yeah, together.
Meet.
All right, well, let's do it. We'll just do it like this.
Yeah, let's just do it regular.
No.
This one had more views. Cool.
All right, cool. Sweet Georgia Brown.
Yeah, Sweet Georgia Brown. Yeah, happy birthday, Robbie!
I pulled into Nazareth, was feeling about a half past dead. I just need some place where I can lay my head. Hey, mister, can you tell me where a man might find a bed? He just grinned and shook my head. No was all he said. Take a load off Benny. Take a load off Benny. Put the load right on me. I picked up my bag. I went looking for a place to hide. When I saw Carmen and the devil walking side by side,
I said,
hey, Carmen, come on, let's go downtown. She said, I gotta go, but my friend can hang around. Take a load off Benny, take a load for free. Take a load off Benny.
It's
Matt Dre's birthday, too. Oh, Miss Moses, there's nothing that you can say. It's just old Luke and Luke's waiting on the judgment day. Well, Luke, my friend, what about young Annalise?
What a Levi!
You said, do me a favor, son, won't you stay and keep Annalise company? Take a load off Benny, take a load for free, take a load off Benny.
Love the band.
Also, Jimmy Crespo, Aerosmith.
She sent me if I spread a leak.
Damn the way.
Oh, shit.
They're too good.
All right, the next song we're going to do, if we can get to 125 or 150, we will do Loveful by the Cardigans because it is the drummer of the Cardigans' birthday as well.
Nice. That song rips.
Yeah.
That's one of the best songs ever.
Love me, say that you
love me. That song is top 10 best songs ever.
Yeah,
like, up against Mozart and...
Oh, it's also the dude from Owl City's birthday. Fireflies.
What's that song? How's that
one? Seattle? Oh, yeah.
Are they from Seattle?
Seattle. I think they might be from, like, Bellingham.
You're from Seattle, right? Do you like, Macklemore?
Oh, I love it.
Do you go to the thrift store?
I go to the thrift shop. I go to the Valley Village.
So you know.
All right, guys, we have 13 watching, 22 likes, one dislike, and we have 26 minutes on the clock here to complete the show. We are at what? 106.51.
Yeah. What does it say? 106.51. So we broke 100. That's nice.
What if I do buy one get one free right now? Right now, buy one, get one free, everything. Buy
go.
One cassette, get a free cassette for free. Buy one
okay,
record,
y'all.
Get one record for free.
So everyone, now it's BOGO time, all right? So if you want to buy something, keep in mind that you can get something of the same.
They can get a strikeout, buy one, get one free. They can get a shot, buy one, get
everything
one free.
Everything is buy one, get one free. So if you go to the shop, nartapes.com/GTG, and you want to get a tape or a record, or a shirt, and if you get any one of those things, it's buy one, get one free. And in the comment box, just leave what you want for your
free thing.
Stand up
now. We're
going to
stand up
thing.
Now. We got to pump it up. Let's see. Can you see?
So
you can still
let's,
see us. There
let's
we go.
Do. Yeah, that's good. Let's
I'm
going to
piss real quick.
I need hold a PP too.
I'll go first.
So, everyone, you heard it first, right here, right now. It is. Oh, shit. It is BOGO. You know, remember when you were a kid and you had to go to Payless to get shoes? And it was BOGO season, and that's the only time you could actually go to Payless. Isn't that fucked up that you couldn't go to Payless unless it was BOGO?
Well, once they came out with the BOGO, it's like, why would you go any other time?
Well, you would go every other time because you're poor and need shoes. But if you're really, really poor, you have to wait until BOGO. I know, that's what I'm saying. It's fucked up. So everything right now is BOGO in the shop. And so that means if you get us a shot, that's two shots for the price of one. If you want to get us a dab, that's two dabs for the price of one. If you order a cassette, you'll get another cassette for free. If you decide to order some merchandise from us and want to get some physical merchandise like a record or a shirt or a tape, those are all buy one, get one free. But when you check out, please in the note field, in the comment field, leave what you would like as your BOGO item. Just so we're all clear and straight up on what's going on. So right now, we're at BOGO, we're doing the BOGO thing. I hope all y'all can hear. Who's still here? Everyone, if you're still watching, please say what's up in the chat. We really got into singing that song and got a little carried away. So please say what's up. And let us know that you heard us say that it's buy one, get one free.
Not
it's
just
BOGO.
Buy one, get one free. It's only buy one, get one free for the next 15 minutes.
There you go.
It is only buy one, get one free for the next 15 minutes. And I want to do a shot. I got tequila and I got. And you can have me take a drink. It's easy. All you do is think. And go to nartapes.com/GTG. That will be the place for me. Shots that go down in my gullet. I got suggested for mullet. I don't want to cut my hair again, but y'all my friends on the network again. But hey, listen, guys, I need you to buy me more shots. I need you guys to BOGO for the next 15 minutes only. Sheep says BOGO, I'd be on it, but I don't get any spare money till I get paid Friday, dudes. Then I'll be back for sure. Well, there won't be BOGO on Friday. We're gonna be in fucking San Francisco area. Austin says, I just got laid while watching, boys. Is this peak gnar?
Oh,
wow.
Yeah.
That is beauty, baby. I'm gonna punch a hole in the dome. Guys, you know what I'm talking about, right? I'm a bunch of ho ho ho. I'm gonna drink the rest of this coffee and see what happens.
I'll be texting you at night. I think of you
at night. I'm texting you.
I almost sang that at karaoke.
Read that last. Read that last comment.
Austin or Sartorius. Sorry. Oh, Austin says I just got laid while watching. Boys, is this the peak gnar? That's pretty cool. That's tight. So not just did you get laid, you were watching the show and you put in that order for the ice cream dog tape. Sick. That's tight. Very good. Very, very good, Austin. I like that. That I like. That's what I'm trying to train myself to say now.
We got 23 that likes and one downvote and 15 watching. Where is Funko Poo Butt says? That is a good question.
I don't know. When he said he was going to go hang out with certain someone, I kind of half expected that he wasn't going to come back.
Mm-mm. I want to know where is Uncle Fungo.
We do a shuffle. All
right, guys, you have 10 more minutes of the BOGO. Buy one, get one free, any enamel pin or t-shirt or record or tape or shot or strikeout. Everything is BOGO for the next 10 more minutes. Can we do this?
Yeah. 10 minutes.
BOGO.
Let's cap it at midnight unless we get
BOGO, 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 BOGO.
Who says, where's Jimmy? Jimmy, just say hi for 5 seconds.
Is that Giamatti?
Yeah, I set that as a flower.
BOGO, 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 BOGO,
BOGO. Where? You spelled where wrong.
Explain this.
How do I explain this? It's crazy. It's a new ice cream dog.
Louis. Stoner's Cup.
Yeah, nice. Stoner's LA Cup. The memories. Buy this new cassette. It's the new free weed. If you guys have heard any of the... Yeah, that's right. This is the new ice cream dog. Get it. Sup, Pooh Butt?
If we can get to 150 before midnight, we'll play the new memories video somehow. Can you do that? Isaac, you can play like the memories video off of Vimeo, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so if we can get to 150... Oh, we made a sale!
Here we go.
Every single day I'm doing my thing. Every single day I'll be doing my thing.
The memories, stoners, freebies, and such. I guess I just cuss too much. And I always say, fuck this shit, but I never, ever, ever, ever deal with it. What was it?
It was for memories, thing about drinking shirt.
Nice!
So, I'm thinking about drinking.
I'm thinking about drinking.
Gonna put
I'm thinking about
off.
Drinking.
Hell yeah.
Alright, what other shirt do you want then?
You put it in there.
Cool.
We go.
All right, we
That's
have.
How you do that BOGO.
8 minutes left of BOGO time.
If you want that BOGO sale, you're gonna have to put it in within the next 8 minutes. Highly recommend you do it soon, because we got our guys working around the warehouse and they're gonna be off the clock in the next 10 minutes. So cool. You're gonna want to get that in ASAP.
If we can get another sale in the next 3 minutes, we will play.
New memories video?
The new White Fang song for a second.
Alright, there you go, you heard it here. We'll play a brand new White Fang song live on the air that you've never heard before. Guaranteed. It'll be the first time. So let's get a sale in the next 3 minutes. And that sale is going to be BOGO too, which is also insane in the membrane. Hey!
You can look into my eyes and realize that I like cheesecake more than pies.
It's cheesecake.
What? Sartori says, let's get a Jerry freestyle. You're going to tell them exactly what they need to do if they want to get you a freestyle
idea. Oh, yeah. If you guys want a freestyle, you're going to have to go to nartapes.com/GTG and put in a donation. It's pretty simple. It's not hard to do, and I'll give you the best dang freestyle you've ever heard in your guys' life.
So give it on up. Let's see what you can do. I'm down to freestyle for you. The hypotenuse says, this stream looks like some kind of Napoleon Dynamite outtakes reel. Huh, that's so funny. I like outtakes. I wish the whole movie was outtakes. It's so funny to me. Remember that? That stand-up?
Yeah.
Great show, guys, says Death Think. You thinking about death? Death is upon us.
You're leaving.
Goodbye.
I'm sleeping.
This, well,
you're leaving.
Safe, have fun, and saddle. No worries.
Interrupt. Oh.
Always a place.
Have fun at the
spot.
We will.
We need to make another sale. We have 6 minutes left of the BOGO.
Let's get that BOGO sale in, you guys. That means you're going to buy something and you get something for equal or lesser value. That means you buy a cassette, you get another cassette.
Yeah, I think are you guys gonna shove stuff up your ass tonight? No, that was Funko. I don't shove anything up my ass, you fucking ass.
I might do it, but not on camera, just because I like the way it feels in private. So, we'll see, I'll think about it. I have a perfectly
like
good milk jug at home.
I like how your privates feel.
Let's be private about it. Yeah, we got a few minutes left of this BOGO sale. It's going off in the BOGO house. We got these guys in the warehouse. They're trying to pack up all your BOGO sales, and we're going to cut it off pretty soon on those BOGO sales. So get ready for it. Get your sales in. Highly recommend getting the Thinking About Drinking shirt, maybe another size, maybe a smaller size for your little sister. Something like this.
Morgoth says, Jimmy, eat the egg. Death thinks, are you guys homosexual?
No. I'll eat an egg if you...
How much for an egg,
Jimmy?
Booba says, Fungo put something up as ad on cam, ass. Puss says, woo, BOGO! Yeah, Dale Boone, BOGO only for the next 5 more minutes!
Whoa! Whoa, BOGO! Oh, shoot! Win your ice cream, dog, boy. $5. Tastes like an ice cream dog. This tape.
Hey!
Hey!
Oh, hell yeah.
Oh, hell no.
If you put stuff up your butts, I'll buy a bunch of shit, guys. Well, if you buy a bunch of shit, then we'll put stuff up our butts.
There you go.
Oh, hell no.
Who says Dringe? Who says y'all gay?
Yeah, that's true, though. I'm pretty happy.
Dude. Hell yeah.
Having any opinion about that means that you even know what the universe is, and that means that guess what, you don't, because you don't even know how to donate buttons.
Yeah, donate. It's easy. It takes a simple amount of seconds.
I didn't know Ron Jeremy Jr. did gay porn. I'd be so sick of Ron Jeremy. He was my dad, and I did porn too.
Just like your dad.
You're much taller than me, son.
You find yourself being 65.
Yeah, you're much taller than me because he's short.
Yeah, he's got a humongous refrigerator full of food at his house, I bet.
Yes, he does. He does.
Now he's got a big cock.
Oh, Tambo says the song service tape is still not listed. The LP is.
The LP, there's no tape.
Just buy yet. Believer pack and have that be part of the your thing. Can I have one of those, Isaac?
Yeah, take that.
Do
one.
You believe?
Give me this.
There's no tape yet.
Give me this, Isaac.
Hey,
put this one back.
Tell me to
put this one back in the fridge.
Will it have to be a double?
Throw this back
cassette?
In the under fridge.
Chrissy says, did you ever finish the second bowl? I believe that we did.
Yeah.
We did finish the second bowl. Look.
We did.
Zach Schrapp says, I'm out, guys. I'll holla at y'all soon. Yeah, say what's up. Come over.
He's gonna, he'll be
here
soon.
Oh, yeah. Thanks for hanging with us, man. Thanks for donating, bro. Yo, Kimmy!
Damn.
Kimmy, we have 2 minutes left in our BOGO sale.
Got a poo now, too.
What you want?
But Kimmy, I'll give you BOGO right now. If you do a sale, Kimmy, I'll give you BOGO no matter what.
Yeah, I'm going to hook you up.
So that's what it says. Y'all owe me a pass of medicine from one time that I never seen.
All right.
I believe you.
Rewind the footage.
Yeah.
Here, pack it. Pack it, Isaac.
I love that Isaac's in the chats because I get to say it now. Yeah. It's like you're saying
your
name now.
This smells good. Awesome.
It smells
like
mint and chocolate.
White Widow, dude.
Yeah.
That's the one.
White Widow's tight. It's a good strain.
It's so good.
It reminds me of like those mint like chocolate things you get at like Mexican restaurant. Andes?
Yeah, like Andy Mints.
Yeah, Andy's
exactly.
Are sick.
You get
that's
those
why we like it so much.
You
get chocolate mints.
You get those with Lunchables too.
Yeah, they're good.
Real good. Uh-oh, Puba says, I'm going to hit the meds right now myself. I hope it's not some Benadryl.
Oh, I thought we made a sale
for
a second.
Asleep. It's an antihistamine.
When you're moving around your meds, make sure you don't put them in expired pill bottles because then you might think that your meds are expired.
So, guys,
that would be awful.
We have the new Mothman pins, guys. If you don't know who Mothman is, he was a weird thing that people in West Virginia in 1966 saw. If you know anything about West Virginia, that they're still weird and Christian and fucked up. Back then, they were even more weird and Christian and, like, isolated. And they all saw this weird-ass fucking thing. And this is my new pin I did based off the original eyewitness sketch from 1966. And it is available. Kimmy says, my meds are Zannies.
That's tight.
Ah, that's probably why you didn't come to our show in San Diego.
She lives in Mobile.
No, she lives in Mobile.
That shit's far. San Diego is 90 miles from Reno Valley.
So, I don't know. It's
I'm down for drugs, dude. Do whatever drugs
well,
you want.
Well, it's like, when you say your meds are Zannies, that probably means, that probably means you need them.
We passed out of BOGO time. We're out of BOGO.
BOGO's done.
Do whatever drugs you want.
So, like, Taurus was the only one that got took advantage of the BOGO. So there you go, Sartorius. Very good.
On the Narstock flyer, I'm good. On the Narstock flyer, I had a dude smoking a meth pipe, and I was like, it's probably not the best.
Yeah, because someone from Grimble might see that and be really offended.
Or be like, oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to be there all weekend.
Well, just
like,
actually,
there was a couple fools last year that were like, they were definitely like tweaker fools from town. That were like, oh, this shit's happening, and paid to get in, and like, they were totally just, they were tweaking everyone out, but no one could say shit, you know, because like, they paid, and they were good, and they weren't doing anything crazy other than talking, and like, being weird. You can't kick someone out for being weird, and like, annoying, like, that's not fair.
No.
And then, do you remember, I don't know if you were there, but when I did my Skinny Jesus set at the first, I think it was the first Death Stock.
Yeah, sorry.
Dude. I played for like only the locals, and it was like messed out full. Like Wakefield wasn't
play again.
Wakefield wasn't there. No one was there, but I was supposed to do it, and they're like, "You just have to go." And I did it, and then everyone showed up. We're like, "You have to do it again." I was like, "You don't know." And I went to earlier, dude. Like it was gnarly.
Really
it was
funny.
Fucking gnarly.
That's so funny.
Sartorius says Jimmy kissed me one time. Fun fact.
Huh?
Do you remember that?
No. But
I believe he's from New York.
I'm sure it's true.
In New York City.
Okay, yeah. I don't know. I'd have to see your face. And your real name.
Oh, hell.
And your social security
number. Oh, hell yeah.
And your credit card number.
Oh, hell no.
And the hours you're at work and times that you're your home. And your address.
Oh, hell no.
And the security number on the back of the credit card, too. The 3-digit.
Yeah, there you go.
So your Facebook picture, the picture of y'all kissing, social address, we need the credit card number, the security number.
It's simple, really.
And then Jimmy will be able to remember if he,
Yeah, I'll be able to tell pretty quick, actually.
Yeah.
So
there you go.
Enzo says, hey, Jimmy, how's it going? Good, Enzo. The way you spelled that, Jimmy, reminds me of this kid I went to high school with named Jimmy Knipe. And he spelled it I-E.
You should spell Jerry like that.
J-E-R-R-I-E. Oh, God.
That's so gross.
Yeah, that's funny.
Well, that's like Jimi Hendrix, James, Jimmy, regular Jimmy, but
right.
J-I-M-I just looked nice.
Yeah,
so they did
J-I-M-I
that.
Looks good.
So they did that.
James Marshall Hendrix.
From Seattle.
What's his real name? Last name Hendrix, though?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. Right.
Jimmy was the big part. Like, the J-I-M-I was the big part.
It was fresh. It was cool. It was edgy, man. You know, it was cool.
Oh,
mate. Oi, it's edgy, mate. It's edgy, mate.
Okay, yeah. Okay, groovy, man. Groovy, yeah. I'm Jimi Hendrix, man.
That's pretty good. Yeah, that's a pretty good one.
Is that Andre 3000?
Yeah.
That's
Jimi Hendrix. Oh my god, that movie is garbage.
Like really stunned. Like,
that movie is fucking garbage.
Yeah.
The like the made-for-TV version of that movie is way better. After the first, after that first Memories tour to Europe, remember when we were staying in the motel that one night? They played both of them.
Yeah, right.
So
yeah,
it was like nice to see.
Yeah.
It was nice to see like the B movie one, and then it was nice to see the Andre 3000 one. It was like
Andre 3000 one was worse though. I think
that movie was whack.
It was so bad.
It sucked.
I was like, oh, this is why I never heard anything about this movie.
That movie fucking
yeah,
sucked.
That movie was bullshit, says Margot 666. He's right, it's bullshit.
The B movie, the one that starred the main dude from Friday Night Lights. He's also in
whatever. Anyways,
yeah, that guy was way better.
Yeah.
Boobat says, or Sartori says Ricky's channeling some dark stuff on the keys. Man, spooky. Boobat says it sounds like death.
Man, that's spooky, man.
Man. Do that like Jimi Hendrix.
Yeah, that's pretty spooky, man.
Well, it's weird, because, like, this, how Fools talk in the 60s,
they used to, like, talk like that.
Yeah.
And, like, they would emphasize the words and, like, hang out on syllables
yeah,
like that.
The hard thing, too, about how dialect happened in the 60s and 70s even, is that nobody said the word like.
Yeah.
They never, if you listen
to... California thing.
If you listen to old guys talk, too...
Chief says, you guys got any plans on coming to the East Coast or anything? Memories, White Fangs, or yeah, we will be out there for the Memories in October. So Tori's this Mothman theme. I like that.
That's pretty good. Kimmy says, speaking of movies, Despicable Me 3 is cute as shit. I've only seen the first one really recently, and I was into it. I haven't seen it. I heard that it was disappointing as a fan, if you were a fan of the Minions.
I haven't seen it. I want to see it, though.
Hoobut says, Ricky was in the zone. You were.
If we don't get to 150 in the next 3 minutes, then we're done.
Bam, 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 bam.
The Twilight Zone.
Yes, we got a big day tomorrow.
Satan! 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 Satan!
Kimmy says Lavender Town.
Satan! 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 Satan!
Boone says I haven't gotten the
this shit. Yeah, I have quite a lot of shit. Alright, email me, boo. I'll sort it out. Sartori says that raffle. No, we're on the third raffle right now. And the third raffle happens at 125. Where we did the first two raffles and sang those songs. So there you go.
We're at 127 now, so there's one more raffle.
Oh, yeah, we're at 125 right now, so one more raffle.
One more raffle.
Yeah, Boone, hit me up.
Rocky.
Rocky, you won the third raffle.
Let us know what you want, Rocky.
Very good.
Very good.
All right. 11:59, what's up, y'all? Hail Satan. Satan! Sometimes it's like, fuck with JC. Yeah, fuck with someone, I guess, man. Fuck with I fuck with the Colonel. Alright. Yeah. Boone, hit me up on the Gmail and we'll send out your package. Make a dick. Rock and roll dead. It's time. Kind of a cartoon where it's like the dad's like,
oh, hell yeah, daddy.
It's like he never made it, but like, yeah, he still like, wears the denim
like,
and the leather.
Yeah, he's wearing his basketball
yeah, like, but he has kids and takes them to school and shit, yeah, but he's still like,
he's like, yeah.
ACDC,
bro!
Yeah.
Oh, it's midnight. We are done for the night, guys.
Alright, y'all.
Thank you so much for tuning into the show!
So this weekend, guys, we're going to be at Deathstalk, so we're not going to be doing the shows this weekend, but we will be doing tons of live streams from Guerneville, from the Camp Outback, from Deathstalk. So this weekend, if you see the notification that one of us is doing a live vid, just check in because it's probably going to be something cool that you want to see. It's going to be sick. So thank you guys for tuning in tonight. Boone, you were the last sale, you did it. Hit me up anyways. I still want to talk to you about coming over, so just shoot me an email anyways. Kimmy says Lucy for short, boo, yup. Lucy in the Sky of Diamonds. Alright, let's do diamonds. Alright guys, so this is it. Do the last words and I'll
shut
it down right now.
Hey guys, I wish it could have been more. I wish the show could have been more money, and I wish we could have had more Funko. Wish we could have had more of everything, but, you know, that's the way it is. We have to leave early tomorrow. Morales, Ricky is fucked up. Yeah, I'm pretty drunk, but I'm mostly tired. I was up till 5 in the morning recording White Fang stuff with Funkle, and that shit was exhausting. Hey, you know what? We should play the Memories video for him anyway.
Let me
start
that.
So, guys, we're going to play the Memories video for you anyway, and it's on Vimeo.
It's, private?
Yeah, there's a link.
I have the rough.
It is. It's newer. It's same link.
Same link?
Yeah.
Okay.
And the same password of the character
yeah.
of... Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, guys. So if you guys are feeling generous, please donate because I'm showing you the video before anybody else is seeing it. And...
Is this okay?
Because
it's going to... Like, the thing is, it's going to be up. Fuck it. They deserve it.
Yeah.
Y'all deserve it.
No, but it's gonna be it's gonna be up. So
hold on one sec. Right.
I don't know. Maybe they didn't actually donate enough for it.
Yeah, I don't know if we should, to be honest with you.
No, yeah, they didn't donate enough.
Alright, because it's gonna be up on this video tomorrow too, before it's out. I'm not sure.
Yeah, we'll just cut the stream, guys. Thank you very much. We'll see you next week. We will hopefully be on next Tuesday. Sartorius, yeah, you donated, but... Yeah, but this is Narcave's Night Live. We have all so much fucking new merchandise. I'm sorry. Yeah, Sartorius, you put in that money. But you...
You did.
But I can't put the video on because you did. No... Not very many people did donate. And honestly, fucking, I try to stay positive in this show. I don't try to be, like, coming down on you guys. But the 125, yeah. Like, to some people, that might be a lot of money. For us, that, like, barely paid the rent today for the fucking, like, electricity and the internet and stuff. So, yeah, I don't want to fucking show the video. I would have shown the video if we had gotten to our goal. I gave you fucking free BOGO! I'm not going to fucking play this stupid fucking video for you guys for nothing. You all didn't fucking donate. Some of you did. But there's still people that are watching that didn't fucking donate anything. I'm not gonna fucking play you a video for free. No. Fuck that. We got the 125. That's not very much, dude. We used to get 100, we used to get 200 every fucking time we did the Night Tapes Night Live Wednesday show. And we have so much fucking new merch. Whatever, dude. I'm not doing this. I'm not doing this free video for you guys. No. You'll wait for the premiere. Barely anybody's even ordered the fucking record. No. Fuck it. Fuck it. We're out of here. Alright, I'm not mad actually, though. I love you guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. I'm not playing the video for you, but I did love you guys at one point in my life. I did love you guys. I'm just joking. Kimmy says, "Oh, dude, I'm sorry, Ricky." No, I am, like, I'm laying it on pretty thick. I'm not being that. It's, like, tongue-in-cheek. Okay. Morgoth says, "Gnar greed is real." Okay, yeah. Free entertainment at least four times a week. Gnar greed is real. Okay, Morgoth, thanks for that nice little comment to leave me out. Kimmy says, "Night, babies, night, Kimmy." Good night, you guys. We will be at Deathstalk. I hopefully will have some of the Gnarstalk pins left over and some of the Mothman pins, but we'll see. And it's great to see you guys as always. Morgoth, Gnar greed is real. That is a mean thing to say. And I'll see you later. And I'll remember that, Morgoth. And I bet Funkle's gonna have something to say about that as well. You still love me? Yeah. Okay, we'll see. I'm just kidding. No, I love you too. And, the records will be here, and the tapes, and the CDs for the Memories Royal United Song Service next week. And we will be on the Paranormal Narcast on Tuesday if we make it back time. See you guys. Good night.